kick into the end zone. Look at this. Let's take a chance. Why don't you? Jordan Brown out of the end zone. Jordan Brown. Woo, what a move that was. Look at Brown go. That's how you start a ball game. Combination of Michael Jordan and Jim Brown was Jordan Brown. 11 seconds into it, and we're already excited.
Jordan Brown said, you can throw these patties on the ground if you want. I am taking this thing out. And he went to, oh my goodness. That's a knockout. Those gloves hit the ground. What a return to start this game. And he has got this crowd electrified.
So wonderful starting field position for Texas Tech. Officially, that's going to be a 67-yard return. Tyler Shuck last week, pedestrian numbers, but didn't make the big mistake, and his team won.
And it was blistering cold in Ames, Iowa. He was big when they needed him most, though.
The senior, Sir Roderick Thompson, starts with the ball, and he gets thrown to the ground. Ball comes loose, and it's picked up by Oklahoma. Ball wasn't ruled down, and it's Ethan Downs on the recovery. Oh, what a turn of events. We're barely wiping the sleep out of our eyes, and we've already had two game-changing plays.
My goodness, Texas Tech is trying to run a trick play, but the problem is right there over the nose, he busts through right there. That's Jordan Kelly, big number 88, and just ruins the entire play. And then the talented end, Ethan Downs, picks it up to rumble and rumble. Everybody thought this play was over, like it was an incomplete pass. That's a fumble on the ground and a big change of events for Texas Tech.
Ethan Downs. Look what I found.
Defense picking up right where it left off a week ago.
So much for that 67-yard kickoff return by Jordan Brown. Drive lasts all of one play for Texas Tech. And now Oklahoma has the ball, led by Dylan Gabriel.
You usually don't switch quarterbacks this quick, right? We're on the other side with the Sooners. Dylan Gabriel was so good in that first quarter, but just couldn't capture a lot of that same success throughout the game. Let's see if he can play a more consistent game today.
Gabriel, quick hitter. This is Jahlil Farouk. Farouk makes a man miss down to the 38-yard line.
Dylan Gabriel's pass complete.
Nice safe pass from Dylan Gabriel and a pickup of 7 yards on first down. A lot of weapons offensively, as per usual, when you think about an Oklahoma offense. Eric Gray in the backfield next to Gabriel. Farouk in motion. Gabriel. And out of bounds was Mims. So it'll bring up third down and 3. Let's take a look at your starters for Oklahoma. Center of note, second consecutive start, Robert Congell. Quarterback center exchange, the snap always vital. There's your skill position players. Drake Stoops, big game a week ago. Marvin Mims has had a whale of a career. Inside run. Not going to get there. Jalen Hutchings with the stop. Ball comes loose, and the Red Raiders head the other way, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
It's like OU is going to line up to go for it. That's a nice job by Jalen Hutchings in the middle of the line of scrimmage, making sure that he stays stout and not allow Gray to get going.
So on fourth down and 2, early decision for Brent Venables. They're going to go for it. Gabriel wants a bunch, has a man. It's Mims. Got it! Touchdown, Oklahoma! Rolling that ice on fourth and 2, and it comes up with a 37-yard touchdown.
Short yarders, this play works because of all the window dress. You're just going to get a regular corner route from Mims there, but Stoops coming back in motion, you give him the play action there, the safeties roll up, and now you've got Mims, the fastest player possibly on the football field, running through the defense for a touchdown. Texas Tech kind of gambled there and went to kind of a zero coverage to make sure they get enough guys in the box to stop the run, and they pay for it.
Zach Schmidt to attempt the extra point.
Yeah.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy. 7-0 lead for Oklahoma. Frisco, Texas' own Marvin Mims, 37-yard touchdown reception against the Texas Tech Red Raiders. Remember, Texas Tech started with the football, but on their first play from scrimmage, they fumbled it away, recovered by Ethan Downs, and the rest is history for Oklahoma. Now Texas Tech will get another chance. Let's see if Jordan Brown will be as frisky with this kickoff. Brown had a 67-yard return a moment ago. And this time, just kind of chill. Give us a chance to look at the Texas Tech starters on the offensive line. Rogers, right, Wilburn, Jackson, and Mills, left to right. Already saw Sir Roderick Thompson, the senior, playing his final game in Lubbock.
Wide receivers didn't get a big opportunity to have gaudy stats a week ago. I mean, this offense was kind of pedestrian, right? They just made the plays when they needed to at the end of the game to go win it. But it was cold. I'm just telling you, right? It was cold. We were there. It was cold in Ames, Iowa. So a lot better weather here. You expect to see Shuck be able to use that talented arm that he brought.
Shuck now with his fourth start. Baron Morton, four starts. Donovan Smith, four starts.
4-4-4.
The quarterback room. Out in space, catch is made. Jaron Bradley. That's a nice gain on first down. They're going to give him 7, maybe 8.
I love the start, right? Get him a completion early. Let him see completion because that's going to prove to be conducive to success.
Thompson patiently through the center of the line, picks up 5 and a first down. Defensively, Oklahoma, Brent Venables telling us his defense has gotten better late in the season.
You saw Big Jordan Keller make the play at the beginning of the game, and then Danny Stutzman has really come on late, the linebacker number 28.
Stutzman and Okwuegbu, both just phenomenal numbers. Sean White is a game changer as well.
Nice job there. This is the quarterback's worst enemy. Jalen Redman does a very good job. Can't get to the quarterback, so he reaches his big paw and stops the ball from getting to an open target.
So second down at 10. Miles Price, the man in motion. Shuck keeps it, and the pass is behind the tight end, Baylor Cup. All of a sudden, it's third down and 10 for the Red Raiders.
Don't hardly ever see that from Shuck, where he just absolutely misses him, right? He's running left, and some people say, well, it's a little tough for a right-handed quarterback. That's not the case. Cup is right in front of him. He just misses that throw. Wouldn't have got a whole bunch, but you don't expect to see Shuck miss a throw like that.
Third down and 10.
They tried to go with the quick fake snap to see what OU was going to be in on defense, but they didn't really show much.
Shuck down the right side, nobody home. Closest man to the football was C.J. Colden, senior corner from Wyoming, the transfer who has played phenomenal last couple of weeks. And it's fourth down and 10.
Yeah, for Texas Tech, they tried to go to the fake snap, and it usually works, right? You get the defense to show your hand, but when you look at the back end, they didn't move at all, right? He gave the fake snap, they didn't move at all, so it really didn't give any answers for Shuck or the coordinator.
Austin McNamara to punt it away. No fair catch. Mims taking a chance out across the 30. Tackled by Teeter. 49-yard punt, 16-yard return. Dylan Gabriel and the Sooners had the ball with 12:22 remaining in our first quarter. Second possession for Oklahoma. They already lead Texas Tech 7-0. And now it's time for our Champions Mindset, sponsored by Hampton by Hilton for this day.
For OU, you've got to get through the trash on the second level. Coach Venables said they had a bunch of opportunities in those three quarters they didn't score last week to get big plays, and they have to play with a game 7 mentality. That's what OU has to play with on the road. And for Texas Tech, they have to withstand that first half storm from OU. They do really well in the first half characteristically, and Texas Tech has to withstand that, and they have to ride the back that's hot. And it's the proverbial back and the actual back. Whichever running back is in the game is playing well. Even though the rotation may suggest that they come out, they have to ride that guy, and those running backs understand it and encourage it.
There was a holding penalty on the return. That's why Oklahoma is backed up inside their own 10. Just to get him some breathing room, they throw it out to Drake Stoops, and he's able to get 9 yards on first down. Oklahoma, 3-5 in Big 12 play. The late handoff, Eric Gray out to the 25-yard line. Show you who the starting defenders are for Texas Tech. Starting that defensive wall where you see that there is no Tyree Wilson, probably their best defender. He is out for the year with a foot injury. He's decided to get ready for the NFL draft, so he is done. Spinning catch made by the tight end Braden Willis. Oklahoma getting yards and bunches. That's a gain of 11.
It's a very good job of going off of what they've done. They've thrown the screen well, and they sneak the tight end right down the seam, and Gabriel throws a really nice pass. This is a lot of what we saw last week against OSU.
Little pop screen. They send it to Stoops, who got crunched. Josiah Pierre saw that one coming.
Josiah Pierre has been really, really good for this Texas Tech defense. He's been outstanding, securing and holding that edge nice and strong. He did a very good job there.
And we were impressed with him last week in Ames against Iowa State. Gray, nice little wiggle in the hole, gets out across midfield and picks up a whole bunch of extra yards before Kosai Eldridge can bring him down.
Again, Josiah does a good job, but good job by the offensive line of Oklahoma State making sure that they kick out and allow Gray to sneak through.
Gray got an extra 13 with Eldridge on his back. Gabriel wants a bunch. Incomplete. Looking for Farouk. And there's a flag down.
It's a little early. That's an outstanding throw and a nice job of Dunlap, who is back from injury, getting back and trying to make a play. He's beat, and he jumps in just a little bit early, stops him from being able to catch the ball. Nice job and nice throw by Dylan Gabriel.
Derek Anderson is today's referee.
There's no foul for pass interference on the play.
A little bit of home cooking, and the Red Raiders will take it.
Well, I mean, they're very happy to get Dunlap back because he's their best cover guy. But you can see right now, he rakes across, and he stops him from catching this ball. Even the fans of Texas Tech are at home saying, we got away with one.
Yeah, they did. Well, it's senior day for Malik Dunlap, and they just gave him an extra batch of roses right there.
Yeah, good for him.
Second down and 10. We move on. Gabriel scanning. And did Mims stay in? Yes, he did. Marvin Mims has been dynamic in our first quarter. That's 17 more for number 17.
Dylan Gabriel's doing a very good job with the pump fake. They ran a sluggo there. That's the slant and go by both the inside and outside receivers. And then he pins him on the sideline with that cover two half safety from Texas Tech deep.
Gabriel keeps it. Gabriel has the first down and slides for his own safety. But the chains will move. Gain of 11.
That's what he can do, right? This is a design quarterback run. He reads Smith, the defensive end, and he finds his way through and gets down. That's very important, but he has the first down. So many quarterbacks you see, they slide prematurely before the first down, and you don't have it. He gets the first down and then starts to slide.
Timeout, Texas Tech. This is their first of the half. Timeout on the field.
Texas Tech starting to leak a little bit of oil. They call timeout. Back in a moment. Oklahoma rolling. They've already gone 8 plays, 77 yards. They picked up 5 first downs. Eric Gray's been a big part of what they've done. Eric Gray has just passed to Marco Murray in the building, running back coach for Oklahoma.
How cool is it got to be Gray and have DeMarco Murray coaching you, and to be DeMarco Murray and have the guy you coach pass you?
Eric Gray not only passing DeMarco Murray, he's also passed Chris Brown already today. He's now 16th on the all-time list for single-season rushing yards at Oklahoma. And everyone knows that Oklahoma's had some great runners over the years. Kosai Eldridge brings down Gabriel. That'll be a loss of a yard.
They bring pressure, right? You can see him inside right there trying to get in. Very nice. It's a nice little stunt they did with the linebackers to get to Gabriel. The offensive line did a pretty good job picking it up and gave him a little bit of time, but he didn't have anywhere to go with the ball. Nice job by that Texas Tech back end.
Second and 11. Gray. Moving on up that list, down close to the first down marker. It's going to bring up third down and short. A 9-yard scamper for Gray. drives, two tutties for Oklahoma. They're an extra point away from a 14-0 lead.
You got guys pulling the opposite way, and you're going to get a tight end out in the flat. Very nice job, a nice diagram by Oklahoma, but a very nice job by Gabriel. You see him, he sees the edge stopped and covered, so he stops his feet, drives the ball, gets it to his talented tight end, touchdown Willis. Very nice design by Oklahoma, but an even better job by Gabriel making sure that play works.
A talented tight end now has six receiving touchdowns on the year. And oh yeah, that drive started at the 7-yard line. 11 plays, 93 yards in 2 minutes and 58 seconds. The Sooners rocking it on a Saturday night. They lead 14-0. Dylan Gabriel has led two touchdown drives here in our first quarter. The most recent one, a 93-yard drive. 11 plays, capped off with a touchdown pass from Gabriel, who has been the truth. That's now two tutties for Dylan Gabriel in our first quarter.
And my keys, I said, what does Texas Tech have to do? They have to withstand the first half storm. They're not doing a very good job of that right now. Let's see if they can find some rhythm with Chuck in this offense.
Jordan Brown brings it out of the end zone for the second time. And this time is not nearly as productive as his first return of 67 yards. He is dropped, and it's going to be a difficult starting position for Texas Tech. Sunday on Fox, we got a huge doubleheader. First is Tom Brady and the Bucs taking on the Browns. Then in America's Game of the Week, the Rams going to battle Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. It all kicks off at 1 Eastern. Check for the game in your area.
Did you see Patrick Mahomes last week in L.A.? I mean, oh my goodness. Don't score with too much time on the clock, because this guy is going to go down and kill you. He was outstanding.
Third offensive possession for Texas Tech, and almost a big-time boo-boo. Shuck just got it out of there, and multiple whistles blowing.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 75 offense. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Jacoby Jackson. How quickly did they get Patrick Mahomes' number?
Oh, yeah. He's been outstanding in the NFL. He was electrifying at Texas Tech as well, but nobody saw how good he is at the next level coming.
You should get a little bit of a buffer, a little grace period before they retire your number.
Get that number up there before he's the best ever.
Pretty convinced, yeah. Quick hitter, no chance at all. The catch is made by Xavier White, but he is just leveled. We talked about C.J. Colden coming up late in the year, and that's an example of what he can do.
It's an outstanding job of him just reading. Takes a couple read steps back and then shoots the gap. Right? It can hurt you if they find a way to go with the fake screen and go down. But he did a good job of being patient. And as soon as that ball was out, he was flying down.
White's the man in motion. Pressure. Shuck gets it off. It's complete. Short of the line to gain. Catch made by Price. It's going to bring up third down and 3, maybe 4. So the drive started with the negative play with the penalty on Texas Tech, and now they're trying to work uphill. It's third down and 3, and another flag is down, and this is going to be against Texas Tech.
False start, number 13, offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Brady Boyd, the infraction. Joey McGuire is not happy right now.
Usually these type of penalties happen for the away team, right? The crowd's too loud, but right now Texas Tech cannot get out of their own way, and Coach McGuire can't be happy.
So third and 3 turns into 3rd and 8.
They're man-to-man, one high defense.
6-man coming in the pressure, and down goes Shuck. He's brought down at the 1. There were 4 Sooners around him. David Okwuegbu, Jalen Redmond, and others.
They show what they're going to do. They bring the guys up into the line of scrimmage. Texas Tech does a good job of motioning to give Shuck some answers to know, is it man-to-man coverage? He sees that, but they bring 6, too many. Great job. We talked about Stutzman and how he's come on late in the season. He continues to improve, continues to mature, and he makes a big play there.
This Oklahoma defense all season long has been elite in sacks and tackles for losses. They take chances, but those chances usually get home, Devin Gardner. That's a huge thing when you take chances and you're successful.
Absolutely. I mean, this defense has improved so much. You had to know that a Brent Venables team, as a head coach finally, was going to find a way to play good defense, and they're doing that now. But Dillon Gabriel, he's been really good in the first quarter, especially last week. 14 of 18, 224, three touchdowns. The rest of the game, he just could not find a rhythm. He had some drops, had some missed throws. It was a microcosm of everything you want to see for a team to not put the ball in the end zone. Can he continue on his tear of the first quarter into the rest of the game is the question.
Third possession for Oklahoma. They've scored touchdowns their first two times they've had it. Farouk with the end around. And Farouk down to the 35. 17 yards on first down. Sooners going for the knockout here in the first quarter. Barnes out of the backfield. Javonte Barnes, his first touch, and he gets it inside the 30 to the 29. Dimitri Moore, Krishan Merriweather on the tackle. It's a gain of six on first down. Sooners relentless. Gabriel again wants a bunch. Stoops is interfered with. There was contact, and Stoops and the entire world thinking it's going to be on Marquise Waters, who really had no right to be guarding Stoops that far away from the line of scrimmage.
Pass interference, number nine, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Find the mismatch. You got a safety on Stoops, which is one of the best receivers on Oklahoma's roster. He's going to run away, and a nice job by Waters just grabbing hold, because you'd much rather give up 15. This isn't the NFL where the pass interference call is a spot foul, right? It's only 15 yards, so you'd much rather give that up than a touchdown.
9 minutes into our game, that's already three penalties on Texas Tech. It's cost them 24 yards. First down and 10. Gabriel, too tall, looking for Eric Gray. That time, good coverage. Dimitri Moore.
So nice job. Texas Tech at the point of attack is doing a very good job of getting to the quarterback. And here they get there with four. Big number 97, Tony Bradford. Him and his running buddy, Jalen Hutchings, has done a very good job to this point in the game. But they have to find a way to get to Gabriel faster and keep Oklahoma behind the chains.
Gray brought down. That's what Waters can do. Close to the line of scrimmage. He just wouldn't let go. It's a gain of just one.
So Texas Tech is committing to stopping the run, right? So they got their safety inside the box. When they put Stoops out in the slot, they do walk Waters out there and allow him to cover him one-on-one. They may want to go to that slot fade that they love to throw.
Late substitution. Now both teams are ready to go. Third down and nine.
There's Waters in man with him.
Stoops, one man to beat. Can't beat him. Waters wins the battle this time. So Marquise Waters gets his revenge.
So Waters can run, right? He can play this game where you have him in man-to-man, you get it to Stoops quickly. He can run and go make the play. Where he struggles is he's a bigger guy, so Stoops' quickness he'll be able to use on those slot fades and releases at the line of scrimmage. This is playing in Waters' hands. He does a great job of running all the way across the formation and making that play.
So on fourth down, the field goal unit comes on. Zach Schmidt, 9 for 13 on the year, long of 44. This will be a 29-yarder. On the hold, Michael Turk. And a timeout.
There's no foul on the play. 25 on the play clock.
Okay.
Just didn't get a chance to reset the play clock for Oklahoma. Give them a fair chance to set up, line up without having to rush and make this field goal attempt.
Zach Schmidt from Oklahoma City. Bishop McGinnis High School. Oh, it's a fake. And Turk, incomplete. I think that was a pass. Yeah, it was. It was a pass to Braden Willis. Willis can't handle it. And Oklahoma taking a chance, comes up with nothing.
It's a well-designed play. Willis is going to get an opportunity to get in the end zone or at least get the first down, but he drops it. He drops it. It's a funky throw, right? Willis is going to come here and sneak down the field. All these other guys are going to go this way, and it's going to take the attention of the Texas Tech defenders. Willis sneaks through, and he drops it, right? He's open. He has an opportunity. Now, to be fair, Venables was excited about it, and he sees like, oh, no, it's going to work. Oh, it didn't work. But that's a funky catch, right? He kind of shot it like a basketball, turning over, tough catch for Willis, but he's got to make that play.
Texas Tech has it. Taj Brooks, nothing there. I think maybe one of the reasons they took a chance is Turk has had one of the best weeks a college guy could have. He had a great week punting the football against Oklahoma State 7 days ago, and then he got engaged after the game.
He said, let's give him a congratulations and get him a touchdown pass.
That's right.
Darn it, Willis.
Got the reference. Second down and nine after the gain of one by Brooks. Designed rollout. Shuck. That's his best throw of the day. Nehemiah Martinez has the first down as he gets that close to the 35. 20-yard gain.
It's a very nice job of Shuck. Get on the outside. He wants to throw the backside hitch. Not there. Get on the outside. And how about the throw? Rolling and putting the ball right on the sideline with a little bit of space for Nehemiah to get the ball and go.
Incomplete. Nice coverage played by Colden to take the ball away from Bradley. That's the third nice play that Colden's been involved with this first quarter.
Absolutely. Not a big guy. 5'11", 185, but he does a good job coming up and making a tackle earlier. And on that play, he's in perfect position. You can see him get inside that inside hip, doesn't pass interfere, and propels himself without grabbing. Maybe just a little bit of tug, but the referee can't see it. Very savvy veteran move by C.J. Colden, the fifth-year senior out of Belleville, Illinois.
Second and 10. Trying to pounce it outside, looking for anything, is Brooks. He gains two. So Roderick Thompson and Taj Brooks have been sharing carries all season long. Texas Tech, they've yet to convert a third down.
Yeah, Coach McGuire said he loves these running backs and their relationship because they don't care who gets the share of the carries. Whoever's hot, they stick with them.
Third downs have been an issue for the Red Raiders all season.
Right, so yet again, they try to get the fake snap to see what they're going to get. I don't think they're going to bring this time. I think they're going to drop out underneath all these slant routes.
Option, Brooks. He was able to get past Stutzman, but can't get anywhere close to the line to gain. It's fourth down, and I can't see. You think Texas Tech is going to possibly go for this?
No. So what I suspect is was correct on that last play. They weren't coming, and so they're in position to run outside. Now, if they were coming, it's zero blitz, and that speed option is a perfect play, but they weren't coming. They back out, and they can just run laterally and go make the play. Nice job by Oklahoma. They are playing a game of chess, and it works again that time.
McNamara to punt it away. Mims deep to receive. Mims calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 11. That's a nice hanging kick, 48 yards for McNamara. And Oklahoma's going to begin this drive backed up at the 11-yard line. All right, this has been updated. Your Big 12 standings here in our final week of the regular season.
Yeah, like we talked about, Texas Tech being in that quarterback carousel, they find their way in the mix. Obviously, can't play for a Big 12 championship. But, I mean, what a job Coach McGuire has done in his first season, kind of riding the ship with all these quarterbacks with injuries and different things like that. It seems like every time they got on the roll, right, a guy got hurt or something happened. So that's pretty cool. But TCU, they just continue to win. They had another dominant victory today.
Texas Tech can finish no worse than tied for fourth place in the league standings. With a win, it would be sole possession of fourth. The best finishing conference since going to the 10-team format in 2011. Nice. Form tackle made. Rashad Williams, gain of just one.
Yeah, Rashad Williams, you're going to see him right there. Sitting, waiting, right? Eyes inside so you know it's zone defense, right? He's seen this bubble screen many times before. This is actually not a very good decision by Gabriel. When the team matches heads, you don't want to throw it because now you have an extra guy and you have to force Mims to try to break a tackle after he catches the ball.
On second down, going nowhere is Gray. Once again, defense stiffening for Texas Tech.
Isaac Smith, he's to the left of your screen. He's going to come in and just fly down and grab Gray. yet again in the run pass option or the RPO. Another bad decision by Gabriel. He needs to keep that ball. The defensive end crashed immediately and almost blew up the mesh. You want to keep that ball and roll around the edge because Gabriel can really do it.
Third down and 11. Theo Weiss, the man in motion.
Man-to-man in the slot.
They need to get to the 22. Gabriel. Right at the line to gain and going out of bounds goes Weiss. So a first down for Oklahoma.
It's like they're seeking out Waters, right? Seeking him out. They got Waters on Weiss now. Weiss goes outside. He runs up the field, but Waters tries to scramble and get back, right? He has to get back because he's beat.
The completed pass for a first down. That's under further review.
Oh, I thought that Weiss was surely in bounds.
I mean, it's a little close. I think he's going to be in bounds, but Weiss, he beats Waters down the field. So Waters is scrambling, right? He's scrambling to try to catch up. And when he's scrambling to try to catch up, Weiss does a very good job of just coming back to the ball and posting up on the sideline. Looks like he did a good job of keeping his feet in, but we'll see.
All right, we're taking another look. Ruling on the field was a catch.
The question here will probably be, did he jump from out of bounds to make the play? Dean, what did you see there?
Yeah, I couldn't see during the route, and that's obviously something that we'd have to look at. Looks like he was inbounds there. Now we're going to look at the toes and then the heel, that right foot. It's a normal stepping motion, so the whole foot has to be inbounds. If any part of that foot touches the white, it's out of bounds. Looked like the foot was inbounds. It's close. And again, the ruling on the field was a catch.
Yeah, it looks really, really close, but that's so important. A lot of people don't know the rule of if your toe is in bounds and that heel comes down out of bounds, that means you're out of bounds.
All right, so
right toe down, comes down. Oh, Mims just blocking the camera. Look at Mims doing his job as a teammate.
I don't know. We definitely had the toes in, but close. Did the heel go out of bounds?
Yeah, I mean, we couldn't see it there because Mims saw the camera and he said, I'm getting away.
Indisputable video evidence to overturn.
Dean, did you see Mims there blocking our cameras?
Yeah, we've got to have a little conversation with him going forward about that. But again, it's got to be obvious. I don't see enough to change this here.
Mm-hmm. All right, here's Derek Anderson with our ruling.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. First down.
It would have been either confirmed or overturned if not for Mr. Mims. Because of Mims's being in our shot, that means the stance means that it just we can't make anything definitive of what we saw. So it's first down and 10 for Oklahoma. This is very similar to that first quarter a week ago against Oklahoma State, when the Sooners blitzed the Cowboys to the tune of 28 points.
Single high safety. Looks like Texas Tech is going to be in man-to-man. I wouldn't be surprised if they don't try to take a shot here.
Gray bounces off a couple of would-be tacklers and gets to the 31-and-a-half. Senior from Memphis, Tennessee, Eric Gray. Began his college experience in the SEC, played for Tennessee. Second straight carry for Gray. Hurdles over the line of scrimmage and gets to the 44. He's fun to watch.
He's got a unique ability to slither in and out of tackles and get through small spaces, right? He's not a small guy, but he finds a way to get through small spaces in the run game.
He's already passed DeMarco Murray and Chris Brown for the single season on the single season rushing list for Oklahoma.
Josiah Pierre comes back in the game. You can see the wholesale changes for Texas Tech because OU did substitutions.
That is a backwards pass. LV Bunkley Shelton. That was a fun looking play, but it didn't add up to much.
And who's that on the tackle? Just came in the game. Josiah Blair does a great job of staying home. He stays in position. Pierre, he stays in position and then gets outside and sets the edge yet again.
Second down at 10. Javonte Barnes. A yard. And it's third down and long. So second time on this drive that Texas Tech has forced a third down and long. First time they couldn't get off the field. We'll see what they can do when we come back for our second quarter. First quarter was all Oklahoma. They lead 14-0. Through 15 minutes in our ball game, it has been all Oklahoma, but a bit of good news for Texas Tech and their fans. One of the legends, Michael Crabtree, being honored here between the first and second quarter. Going to be inducted into the College Football Hall of Fame come December.
Boy, was he good, man. I loved watching Michael Crabtree, even in the NFL as well. Got a chance to play in some conference championship games at the next level in Super Bowl, but he was a good football player, a great football player at Texas Tech.
Texas Tech, they need to stop here. Texas Tech trying to get off the field. Oklahoma has a third down and long. Second time they've had a third and long on this drive. Third and nine, technically. Barnes in the backfield next to Dylan Gabriel.
Man-to-man defense again for Texas Tech. I think they're bringing
pressure. Gabriel. Oh, my goodness.
Oh.
That ball was caught. Marvin Mims.
Goodness.
How do you do? What a play.
He's just going to go in the slot fade. You can see him in the slot when he's motioning across. Dunlap is a little, he does a good job of collisioning him, and that's legal at the
pass
college level.
Oh, wow. Defense.
Wow.
Several knees decline. Goes over to the play is a first down.
Level of difficulty, 12.6.
Oh, my goodness.
Marvin Mims with Oklahoma's best catch this year, probably the best catch in the Big 12.
Give me that. What a catch.
Just staggering. Gain of 30 for Mims. I want to just admire that a little longer. We play on. First and 10. When he's running like that, he's a Roman Gabriel. Dylan Gabriel hit hard out of bounds. We see a flag. Kosai Eldridge drills him, and there is a flag down. What have we just seen the last two plays?
And Texas Tech took away the opportunity to see that catch again. Man. Clearly out of bounds.
Derek Anderson's been busy.
All right, so he's not out of bounds there, but it's just, it's this. You're driving him, and then you fall all over him. You walk over him. I mean, it's too much, because that's going to start
after
a fight.
After the play, personal foul, late hit, number six of the defense. Penalties half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
He did a great job. Didn't need it, right? He didn't need it. He got him in bounds, just push him and get away, but he doesn't do that. But how about that catch? Thank you for the time that we needed, Eldridge, because we need to see it again. Give me that. Off of his back, a little bobble and pulled in with the right. You know, Eric Collins hates to say that it's the catching ability. He says it's the glove. But I think that's hand-eye coordination by Mims.
Marvin Mims Jr. has had a really good first half. Tight end Willis down to the five, maybe the four. Game three, second down and goal. Second consecutive week that Oklahoma's offense has given themselves a real good working margin early in the game. Gray to the four.
Texas Tech is leaving Stoops in man-to-man with safeties and sometimes linebackers. I just think that he is in a position to win. They've run a couple slot fades. I wouldn't be surprised they don't get him up on one of those defenders and bring him inside.
Third and goal, four receivers right side. One of them is Theo Weiss, who makes the play and gets a touchdown, but there's a flag down.
Prior to the snap, ball start, number 71, offense. It's a five-yard penalty, third down.
Oklahoma's best offensive lineman, Anton Harrison, cost his team 5 yards and a touchdown.
Yeah, both these teams play extremely fast, right? So what we've seen in the beginning of this game is they're getting false start penalties because they're trying to go so fast and the timing of the snap just hasn't gotten, everybody's not on the same page with it.
Devin, a big lineman, like to play in these up-tempo offenses where you just really got to be in great shape?
Well, you got to get prepared in the offseason, right? The conditioning programs are significantly different for these two programs than, rather, say, a Michigan, right? A Michigan that is a ground-and-pound team where you get your rest. It's a little different. These types of schools, I remember being with Coach Rod in that high-rate spread offense as we got a timeout on the field here from Oklahoma. I remember that, and the conditioning was vastly different than when Coach Hope came.
Oklahoma calls a timeout. We'll be back to Lubbock in a moment. FS1 College Football is sponsored by Hampton by Hilton for the stay. It has been all Oklahoma here on Texas Tech's Senior Day. Texas Tech, they need to stop. They need people to stay engaged. They need a sudden change, something. Third down and goal. Eric Gray, the lone back next to Gabriel. Mims, the man in motion.
Texas Tech going to his own defense, going to get his own blitz off the edge.
Just a three-man rush. Corner of the end zone, that's too easy. There's multiple flags down, but for the moment, it's a touchdown to Mims. I'm assuming that's a pick or something. That was, how did he get that open that close to the end line?
Yeah, they're going to get offensive pass interference on Weiss. I don't think it was, though. I think that, you know, he did a decent job of side. He made a lot of contact. Never.
All right. Pass interference, number 10, offense. The 15-yard penalty, replay third down.
And it's mostly because he drops the shoulder a little bit. Look to the right of your screen up here. It's because he's going to drop his shoulder and kind of lower it, and then he kind of posts up, right? He drops the shoulder. He's looking at the defender, drops his shoulder, clinches, and then he posts up and pretends he's not doing it right. You got to go and just post up for the ball. Don't put your shoulder down and make contact. He does that, and I think that's the right call by the officials.
So Oklahoma is going to be backed up all the way to the 24. Good luck. Third down and goal from the 24. Four-man rush. Gabriel. Nothing doing. Fourth down. So it went from being first and goal inside the 10 to what's now going to be a fairly hefty field goal attempt.
I'm so surprised that Oklahoma didn't attack the middle of the field. Texas Tech safeties were so wide, almost out to the numbers, and it allows Stoops, who's so good at working the middle of the field, to get through there, but they never even sent the guy through the middle. You would think they'd come back to that next time they get down here in that fringe red area.
Last time Oklahoma had the ball, they attempted a fake field goal. I'm here to tell you, they're not going to fake it here from the 24. This is a 41-yard attempt. Zach Schmidt, his season long is 44. Schmidt, center cut. Oh, from A to Z from Zach. Making it happen. And it's a 17-0 lead for the Sooners. Maybe a catch of the year in the conference. Marvin Mims. Wonderful stuff. Marvin Mims still thinking about that unbelievable catch that he made just a moment ago. Mims off to a great start already with four catches, 85 yards, and a touchdown. Field goal by Schmidt just a moment ago. 17-0 is the lead for Oklahoma. Oklahoma's had two touchdowns, a field goal, and the only other time they had the ball, they had a field goal attempt, would have been a chip shot, but they faked it. Texas Tech, on the other hand, a whole bunch of nothing, an abundance of nothing. And they'll have a touchback, ball will be taken to the 25-yard line. Well, the best thing that we've said about Tyler Shuck all season long is the fact that the guy's a winner. He's putting his team in a position to win, and obviously this is not all of his fault, but there are other quarterbacking options for Texas Tech should they decide to go down that path.
Yeah, I think he's been fine. The way this game has started, this is exactly how it started a week ago for them, where, you know, he's throwing good passes, they fumble, and you see the fumble on the first play of the game this week. They just haven't been able to get in the rhythm, but it's to no fault, I don't think, of Shuck.
Four possessions, a fumble, and three punts. Now they start 75 yards away from Pater. So Roderick Thompson makes the first man miss, gets the first down, scoots out of bounds. 12 yards for Thompson. Playing in his final home game, senior from Irving, Texas. One of the all-time greats running the football at Texas Tech. He'll do it again. Spin out to the 45. 11 yards. So back-to-back first down runs for Thompson.
Gain of nine brings up second down.
They say it's a gain of nine, so it's, oh my goodness, second and a half yard. You think that's going to be a gimme, but Ethan Downs says, not on my watch. All of a sudden, they're going to move backwards, and third down becomes a little bit more difficult.
They're going with the same play, but he hugs tight to Rodgers, the left tackle number 76, and he meets the runner before he can get behind him. They run the play, this play three times in a row, right? They run it left, they run it right. He does a great job of diagnosing it, getting in that hip pocket of the left tackle, and finding the ball carrier.
Second and one turns into third and four. Blitz. First down, finally, for Texas Tech. Loic Fungi has the grab and the first down for the Red Raiders. That's the first third down conversion for Texas Tech. Shuck dreaming. Caught. Fungi again. A big play for the Red Raiders. Finally, some positives for this Texas Tech offense. That's a gain of 34.
Shuck drops a dime on the big post to Fungi.
Brooks. Oh, my goodness. Bruising his way down to the 10. Should have been a gain of one. It's a gain of six.
Amazing with a couple good runs from Roderick can do for you. This offense for Texas Tech is in rhythm right now, and they're rolling.
Brooks. Down to the 7-yard line. Danny Stutzman eventually brings him down.
This is more of a zone scheme. They're not pulling any offensive linemen, so you leave it on the running back to find the gap, find which way he wants to go. He does a good job of lowering his pads and continuing to run after contact. That's what you're going to get from this big back, Taj Brooks. He's going to make sure that after first contact, he continues to drive those legs and get extra yardage.
Brooks is taken out, so Roderick Thompson back in on third down and one. Eighth play of this drive. Texas Tech then want to settle for a field goal. Caught. First down. Down to the one, maybe the half yard line, is Miles Price. Key Lawrence saved a touchdown.
It's a nice job by Price, right? Running left, sticking that left foot in the ground, coming underneath and getting as close as he can to the end zone. This is the speed and rhythm that Texas Tech wants to play with. They are exactly where they want to be right now.
And with 10:02 remaining in our quarter,
the field is the runner short. That play is under further review.
We've got an official timeout to see whether or not Miles Price possibly broke the goal line.
I don't think he did, but I mean, this is a nice player. Nice job of him catching this ball going up and underneath. Very nice job sticking that left foot in the ground. Then he gets grabbed and thrown. Ball has to break the plane. From that angle, it's tough to see.
Yeah, it was Key Lawrence who made the tackle. The feet made it into the end zone, but the ball, I don't think, ever did.
That's close. I don't know. That's straight down the line shot. But the thing is, you have a referee watching straight down that line, so it'll be tough to overrule this one. Yeah, I don't think so. It's very close, though, but I don't think he got in.
That both feet are in the end zone, but the ball doesn't appear to be. Dean Blandino joins us now. Dean, what do you see when you look at this replay?
Yeah, that's exactly right. It's not the body, it's the ball. And when that right thigh hits the ground, it does look like the ball is short. Without a shot down the goal line, it's going to be tough to tell for certain. But again, the ruling on the field was short. I don't see anything to change this.
Yeah, I think it's interesting that they go to look at it, because the best view in the house is the line judge, right, watching right down the goal line, and he was right over on it. He said it was short, Dean.
Yeah, exactly. They do have the best look. And again, it's close. It's a potential score, so replay's going to look at it, make sure. And again, it's got to be obvious to change. I would imagine this is going to stand.
Thanks, Dean.
It's giving Texas Tech a lot of time to think of a one-inch play, right? A one-foot play to make sure they get in the end zone here. This drive has been really good, and this is very similar. Almost got a face mask there. This drive has been very similar to last week, where once Texas Tech started rolling, they started rolling, right? They went down and scored. Here's the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. It is first down, Texas Tech.
All right, so momentary disappointment for Texas Tech, but they've got the ball first and goal from the half-yard line.
Surprised they don't get Smith, the backup quarterback, Donovan Smith, number 7. And they love to bring him in and have him for packages such as these, where they put him in the game for him to be a running threat at the quarterback position.
Shuck. Incomplete. He was looking for
Jalen Hutchings.
Yes.
They bring in the big sawed off at the up back fullback position and try to leak him into the flat, but the ball just isn't there. He's open, but he doesn't know how to settle in the hole. He doesn't play wide receiver. Hutchings, you gotta settle down. Can't keep running and get covered. Nice call.
Senior day, they try and get the pass to the senior Hutchings. I like the thought. And now the senior scores. Hutchings with a senior moment. Who knew? Give it to the defensive tackle at the goal line and good things will happen. That's the cool thing about senior days across the country, is you just don't know. You just don't know who's going to be the star.
This isn't just a regular, this might be your best option to get a foot, right? Because Hutchings is an outstanding athlete at that nose tackle position. And when you get him the ball, I'm just telling you, things will move. He got an end zone fairly easy there.
Uh-oh. Extra point is missed. Trey Wolf misses wide left, so Texas Tech has to settle for 6. But the big man, like a dancing bear.
I love a big man touchdown, because you get a big man celebration. Best dressed man in show business there, huh?
Well, you're deflecting. I know you want to talk about it. I'm with Devin Gardner, former Michigan quarterback, and what a day it was for the Wolverines, right?
Oh, they were outstanding. They're outstanding. But we're here. We're here in Lubbock, Texas.
On a bounce, Farouk, and the play is whistled dead. Yeah, I think if we turn the lights back on at the horseshoe in Columbus, we'd still see Michigan receivers running unabated in Ohio State secondary.
Unabated. Well, when you run the ball like Michigan does, it makes it tough to stop the run, right? So what do you have to do? You have to dedicate more guys, similar to the way that Texas Tech is doing for OU, and they've got guys running down the field. And when you do that, if your quarterback can make some throws accurately down the field, you can have a lot of success. So you're going to see OU come back out, and Texas Tech has done a good job of dedicating guys to the run. And if Gabriel can continue to be accurate and get the ball down the field, they can take advantage of some mismatches at the receiver position. OU will be able to run down the field as well.
All right, Oklahoma, a lead of 11 points, 9:45 remaining in our first half. Dylan Gabriel in the backfield with Javonte Barnes, and Barnes is met before he got to the line of scrimmage. That's Robert Wooten on the tackle. It's a loss of a yard.
Gabriel's going to have to keep the ball. This is the second time on a read option play where the defensive end from the backside, who he's reading, comes free, right? He's unblocked for a reason, because you have the option of the quarterback pulling it. Gabriel has to be a little quicker with his read, pull that ball out, and he'll have a lot of space to run.
Barnes back to the original line of scrimmage. Jalen Hutchings just scored a touchdown a moment ago. This time makes a tackle right at the line of scrimmage.
Remember I said it. Texas Tech is dedicating guys to the run. There's nowhere to go. And even when they don't, Gabriel hasn't made the right decision in the read option game. But now you're in an obvious passing situation. I wouldn't expect them to drop Gabriel Black and back and hold him in the pocket too long.
Third down to 10 is a pretty big ask.
Right, similar to Texas Tech, they tried to get the fake snap, but Texas Tech's defense did not move, so no answers were given to the coordinator or Gabriel.
Interesting. They run it, and they're going to get the first down. Barnes needed 10. He got 10.
It's a smart call. You got two safeties deep. You want to get this ball run because, okay, maybe you get the first down, but like I said, you didn't want to drop Gabriel back.
That wasn't a good spot.
Calling short.
That was not a favorable spot for Oklahoma.
I still love the call, though. You don't want to drop Gabriel back in the shadow of his own end zone and allow Texas Tech to get after him. You want to call a play with two safeties deep, run the ball, but I'm surprised they're not looking at this.
So it's fourth down and 1 And the punt team comes on.
Very surprising they're not looking at this.
Michael Turk's got just a mammoth leg. Turk's punt lands at the 33 and will bounce down to the 27. No return, a punt of 56 yards. What's new? That's what Turk's been doing all season long. Well, momentum starting to switch a little bit. It had been all Oklahoma. Now Texas Tech trying to answer a touchdown with another touchdown on the second consecutive possession. Texas Tech, they scored their last time with the football, missed the extra point, but they've got it again. First four drives, a grand total of 26 yards, Devin Gardner. But that's a distant memory considering their last drive was a 75-yard chariot ride to glory.
Initially, they did not withstand the storm, but they can continue to move the ball before the half ends. They'll be able to do that.
Thompson out to the 30-yard line, a pickup of three on first down. Danny Stutzman, we're going to call his name out a lot. Every announcer does. Another tackle for him. Fungie, third catch of the day. And he's out across the 35, a pickup of six. Again, Stutzman with the tackle.
So that's just an extension of the run game. And the run game is also there because OU has two safeties removed out of the box. So they're playing with a light box.
And movement on the line. Both tackles appear to flinch for Texas Tech.
They're going to give it on
ball start,
70.
Number 71, offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Monroe Mills.
I'm going to help him out here. 70, Weston Wright also moved. Both tackles.
Fifth penalty against Texas Tech in our first half. Still with 7 minutes remaining before halftime. Shuck. Incomplete. Wonderful play on the ball by Woody Washington. Great closing speed. He's been steady all season long. And then incompletion makes it fourth down.
I love watching this Woody Washington play. He does a great job as the cover two corner. Right? He sinks and sinks and sinks and knows that he has the speed to get into the flat. He tried to bait the quarterback, Shuck, into throwing it into flat, knowing that he will be able to get there, but he didn't time it perfectly, right? He's a little mad at himself, saying, man, I should have made this interception. I had it. But a nice job of giving what he's not doing and then doing what he's supposed to do in the flat. Very nice job by Woody Washington.
Fourth punt for Austin McNamara. No rush whatsoever. Mims makes the fair catch at the 23. To punt of 48 yards. Tuesday on Fox, it's all or nothing in a massive game for Christian Pulisic and Team USA as they face a crucial World Cup showdown with Iran. Coverage begins 1 p.m. Eastern on Fox and the Fox Sports app. Devin, have you caught the bug? The World Cup bug.
I mean, how about USA, Team USA playing England going 0-0? Right now, everybody thought they didn't win, but England's an outstanding soccer team, and Team USA was able to go 0-0. If you don't know soccer terms, I know you're not a soccer guy. You know, I'm a soccer guy. 0-0 is 0-0.
It's hard to go anywhere and see a TV that's not on the World Cup. It's been everywhere. Ubiquitous, you might say. Dylan Gabriel has a man wide open. Look at Mims. Just going to stroll. Touchdown of the year for Oklahoma. How does a great player like Mims get that open? 77 yards for Mims. And his monster day continues.
Well, the reason he's open is because you got corner blitz coming here. Safety needs to get over the top, but he doesn't. Corner comes, Dunlap, he's going to come in your screen right there. There's no safety over the top. He leaves Mims. Mims is down the field for a touchdown. That's a miscommunication in the back end. They had one like that last week, and after that, they took their safety out and had Tyler Owens, number 18, playing for the rest of the game. I don't know whose fault that was, but it's a miscommunication, and they pay mightily.
Our statistician's going to have some bloody fingers paging through the Big 12 record books. Already, Mims, 5 catches, 162 yards. We still have 6 minutes and 25 seconds left in our second quarter. What a monster first half for Mims.
Malik Dunlap comes on the quarter blitz. I don't know if he's supposed to or not, but if he does, the safety has to get over the top and help. The safety does not get over the top and help, and this is about the easiest touchdown that Mims will score. I mean, probably since Little League.
Mims came into this game.
Corner blitz here, so the safety has to get over the top. He doesn't do it, right? The corner blitz is going, and you can see he's over there, but maybe he's just enticed by the run fake, and the run fake brings him in a little too far, and Mims is naked down the field.
He truly had a 20-yard buffer between he and the closest Texas Tech defender.
Like I said, the easiest touchdown he scored since he was an 8-year-old football. He's probably really good back then, too.
Largest lead of the day for Oklahoma, 18-point stiff arm. And it's a touchback. Texas Tech will start at the 25. Well, Mims, still a lot of that. Big play guy, now with 12 career games with at least one 50-yard reception.
Haven't even gotten out of the half. 5 receptions, 6 targets, 162 yards. That's 32.4 per catch.
Good.
I mean,
man,
he is a big play receiver, but good golly, in the words of my partner, Eric Collins.
Texas Tech had to punt last time they had it. Dangerous pass. That was almost picked off by Deshaun White, who's generally active in the pass game.
Deshaun White, he has to get to this area to make sure. That's the vacancy. He does a very good job. He's even pointing there before the snap. Gets to his hook to curl. He's in position. He doesn't know the guys behind him, but he knows that he needs to be in his area. Great job by White.
White, a 225-pounder. In coverage with good lift. Thompson, second down run. That's what seniors do. His team needed him to make a play, and he did. Broke a tackle at the line of scrimmage and gets the first down with a 14-yard scamper. Always liked Sir Roderick Thompson, what he has done during his collegiate career, all spent in Lubbock.
Such a great story.
Thompson, take two. A 7-yard run on first down. Woody Washington makes the tackle. Now, still plenty of time remaining in this first half for Texas Tech to be able to go into that locker room at the half with some momentum and feeling kind of good about themselves. Oh, my goodness. Miles Price makes the catch. That was almost a pick six the other way. How did that ball get through to Price?
And C.J. Colden has done a very good job reading these quick screens, but how about the ability of Price to have great eyes and hands, right? Eyes and hands with a hand in your face in front of the ball. He still makes the play.
Catch made by Bradley. Jared Bradley gets pushed out of bounds.
Tyler Shuck's pass completes a number 9.
Jared Stutzman Bradley with another tackle. It's a gain of 9. Second Force down and a yard.
C.J. Colden, second and 1.
Shuck, pocket collapsing. And Shuck with a surprising burst of speed. I didn't know he had it in him.
Tyler Shuck, the ball carrier.
And Tyler Shuck makes something out of nothing. That's a gain of 8. These are desperate times for Tyler Shuck. When you know you have a whole fleet of quality quarterbacks that could play at any moment for Texas Tech, you can't suffer too many punts in a row. Empty possessions mean next man up. Just a 3-man rush. And the pass is off a helmet. I thought that was an incomplete pass. But the whistle, and now the whistle blows. And somehow, Shuck makes a one-handed tackle of a 300-pounder. That was Ellison, who somehow Shuck was able to bring down with just almost a pat to the back. Josh Ellison, 6'3", 300 pounds. What's a do-over?
See big number 8, Jonah Laula.
Jonah Laulu.
I did so good earlier. Jeez Louise. Laulu. Great job batting that ball down.
Second down and 10. Oklahoma showing blitz. Shuck, nifty feet. Nice pass. Bradley out of bounds at the 15.
This is some of the poise we saw last week where he gets in a tight spot, but he uses his legs. We saw it early in this drive where he uses his legs to go pick up a first down and shows that burst of speed. There he gets on the edge, sticks his right foot in the ground, comes underneath, and moves to throw. Very nice job and a nice throw on the sideline to Price.
Texas Tech can get one more first down before they head to the end zone. First down at 10 from the 15. Brooks out of the backfield, gets to the 6.
I'm just telling you, Brooks is not turning down contact from anyone. Nice job of getting the ball and being violent as he goes to pick up as many yards as he can.
Gain of 8, second down and 2. 3.5 remaining in our second quarter. And Donovan Smith has come into the game for the first time.
This is a package they love to do, and they put him at running back or quarterback sometimes, and this could be a pass, dude. It's a nice pass as well. He's the lead blocker.
It's a run, Sir Roderick Thompson. Did he? Yes, he did. Touchdown, Red Raiders. The wonderful, fulfilling career of Sir Roderick Thompson adds another page to it.
We've seen him come in packages, Smith. We've never seen him be the point of attack. The guy that is the lead blocker to make sure Sir Roderick gets in the end zone, and Thompson finishes it with a powerful run over the goal line. How about that? We've seen Smith throw it. We've seen him run it, but we've never seen him be the lead blocker. Wow. How about the toughness of your backup quarterback?
Trey Wolf missed an extra point a moment ago. And this time, can of corn. It's an 11-point game. Texas Tech touchdowns on 2 of their last 3 drives. Now down 24-13. We're going to keep it here and wax poetic about what we saw from Texas Tech.
Those aren't great push-ups, though.
Questionable.
He's got to get down.
Yeah.
He's got to get that chest down, man. Especially the way you put your quarterback out there to lead block. The push-ups have got to be better.
And that's only 13 push-ups. He's in trouble a little later on in the game if Texas Tech figures out their offense.
I know, right?
We'll check back in later. All right, 3:09. Now the task for Texas Tech. Their defense needs to stand their ground, hold their water, and keep Oklahoma down and keep momentum on that sideline. Both teams bowl eligible, but since they're bowl eligible, both teams with a chance of having a losing season if things don't go their way. Loser of this game goes to a bowl game and loses, and that's a losing season, something that Oklahoma, man, if you're of a certain age, you have no recollection of. Oklahoma hasn't had a losing record since 1998. Fair catch called for and then muffed.
So they don't get the ball to 25. That's huge, because you call fair catch, you can get the ball to 25, but because he muffed it, he picked it up, took a knee, they don't get it to 25, they'll get it at that spot.
Devin Rulebooks flexing. Coming up, it's the State Farm Halftime Show with Emmanuel Acho and Pete's Poison, Chris Peterson.
I'm interested to see what Coach Pete's pet peeves are this week. You think it'll be, planting the flag in another team's field. That's what Michigan did today after they beat Ohio State.
Oh, I didn't see that. Is that right?
Yeah, they did. They did that. Saw it on Instagram, actually.
Oh, my goodness. First down and 10. Standard issue running play, Eric Gray. And he is out to the 18-yard line.
A lot of time what Texas Tech loves to do, even though they love to have Pierre as the guy at the point of attack to set the edge, they sometimes spike him down and allow a linebacker to fly over the top.
Woo! Kosai Eldridge with some thump. He's going to make it third down.
Bad intentions on that tackle. Man, a quick 3-and-out is not what OU needs, especially the way that Texas Tech is finding their rhythm on offense. But that's what they're facing right here with this 3rd and 4.
Both Oklahoma and Texas Tech with 2 timeouts remaining here in our first half.
One high safety allows Stoops to work and get across the field.
Gabriel. And is it is. Dadrian Taylor-Deverson somehow rips away an interception. As a senior making a play on senior day. What a grab.
What a great job by Taylor Demerson. He's in outside leverage. That's why you think Stoops will go inside. Stoops does a great job of stemming inside and then going outside. He flips his hips and comes underneath. It's risky, but he makes the play.
Woo!
On senior day.
And that means
what a catch. They say the DBs play defensive back because they can't catch. They couldn't catch a wide receiver. Wrong.
Well, the scouting report on Dadrian Taylor-Deverson, he was a great offensive player coming out of Oklahoma City, got switched to defense, clearly still had his offensive skills. And what a special day for the senior to get an interception against his home state team.
Mm-hmm, the way he did it, too, that's a nice football play.
So now, if Texas Tech plays their cards right, they could take this all the way to the half, and they'd like to put it in with a touchdown. Thompson makes the first man miss, has the first down, down to the 14-yard line. 10 yards for Sir Roderick Thompson.
Man-to-man, and Agwebu has no chance in space with Thompson.
Always in hurry-up mode. Texas Tech gives it to Thompson, and he gets out of bounds.
OU is on their heels. I expect Texas Tech will not substitute so they can keep the same bodies out there and continue to lean on them in the run and pass game.
It's a gain of 8. It's a second down and 2.
Uh-oh. They're bringing in that package again with Smith.
Thompson leaves.
Smith up there at the top of your screen outside of the left tackle, Caleb Rogers.
Donovan Smith started 4 games this year as the quarterback.
Here he goes,
and now
back
Smith will be the quarterback. Todd Brooks next to him. Designed quarterback run! Yes! Touchdown, Texas Tech! Brilliant play call by Texas Tech. This game has changed. Just turned on a dime. Donovan Smith was the quarterback earlier this year. 4 starts, was productive, put up numbers, but then got asked to be moved to the side. And he comes in late in the season with a special package designed just for him, and he flourishes in that package. Extra point makes it a 4-point game.
If you're a fan of basketball, you know exactly what I'm talking about. One of the first skills you learn is the triple threat position. You're going to see the quarterback go back and start to play quarterback, right? Let it run. He's going to go back there, and he is going to go quarterback draw. Right, quarterback draw. You got to show pass and then go to the run. Well, he shows pass and then gets in triple threat. Boom! Gives a little jab and then to the cup for a layup. Oh! He played some basketball in his day for sure. The triple threat, the jab, and the score. Filet into the end zone.
Second consecutive week that Donovan Smith has scored a touchdown out of that special package. And Texas Tech seemingly on the ropes earlier in this first half, now within just 4. If they had missed an extra point, this would be a 3-point game. Oh. Texas Tech left a lot of meat on the bone, though. Oklahoma, a minute 28. They can do a lot of damage in 88 seconds.
Eric, do you remember the keys? Withstand the first half storm.
Yep.
Looks like Texas Tech has found a way to do that.
You're spot on. Yeah, Oklahoma fans right now are just remembering what happened a week ago. They scored 28 points in the first quarter against Oklahoma State and then fell apart like a discount lawn chair. They didn't score again in the final 3 quarters. They're going to be tested right now. Can Dylan Gabriel and Oklahoma figure out the offense, which seems to have gone into a bit of a rut?
That's what I've learned watching OU over these few weeks is They do a great job with that first 15, those opening plays, diagramming plays that everybody knows. You practice them a bunch. You know what you're going to call. But when you get into the meat of the game, when you have to call the game from the top of your head, they've kind of struggled to get in a rhythm. Let's see if they can find that rhythm with Gabriel.
Conservative on first down. They give it to Gray to the 30. Oklahoma, they've got two timeouts. That's a gain of five.
Just telling you, 1,200 yards coming into this game on the season for Eric Gray. If you want to find the rhythm for your quarterback, get the ball to your running back, and he will help with that a lot. This is not good for Texas Tech. Josiah Pierre is down on the field.
We've called Pierre's name quite a bit here in our first half. Yeah, he needs a moment. Joey McGuire going to head all the way across the field. Let's take a look, see what happened. Here's number 8. Yeah, you saw that left leg.
It kind of got leg whipped there by number 2, Reggie Pearson, as he's in position trying to make play. You got to know, he's always in the line of fire because he's always at the point of attack. You see him working on his lower body there. This will be a huge loss for Texas Tech. He does so much for this defense. Even though he's usually on one side, he's an outside linebacker, a stand-up guy. He does a good job in his pass drops as he gets up, and he's going to walk off the field underneath his own power. But he does so much for this team in the pass rush game, in the pass drop game, and also just at the point of attack for those outside run plays. So hopefully he can come back with full strength.
It was actually a pretty good moment. I think that was Brett Venables, Oklahoma's coach, who went up. Oh, was that Matt Wells? I'm being told that was actually Matt Wells, who was the head coach prior to Joey McGuire Texas Tech, who of course knows Josiah Pierre. Matt Wells is now an offensive analyst for Oklahoma. And he left the Oklahoma sideline to just give Pierre a pat on the fanny. Second down and 5. Nowhere to go. Wrapped up and brought down. Jalil Farouk can't get away from Taylor Demerson.
Back-to-back possessions for Adrian Taylor Demerson. He has the outstanding interception, and you're not going to see him at the start, but you're going to see him fly into your screen and take this jet sweep away. Very nice job. You don't get Farouk on the ground very often in open field. Demerson does an amazing job, and he's hyped about it.
Oklahoma native Adrian Taylor Demerson having a wonderful first half, and now Texas Tech is one play away from getting this ball back. Texas Tech calls the timeout. They have one remaining. It's third down and 11. What's the thought process here? If you're Oklahoma, how aggressive will you be?
I mean, for Texas Tech, we've seen in their defensive scheme, they play middle open sometimes. They play single high. And I think Oklahoma has the athletes to make sure that they can get downfield. They can get through the middle with the Stoops. They can make sure the Stoops gets one-on-one and even Mims in those one-on-one situations. But Gabriel has to make the throw, and the coaching staff has to trust him to do it. I think they have to drop back and drive the ball down the field to steal some of this momentum back.
They need to get to the 35.
One high. The safety's way, way back.
Run play with Gray. Texas Tech will call a timeout. They'll have an abundance of time.
So we saw this earlier where Oklahoma went to the run game. They started in one high, then moved to two high, and you think that you'd be able to run the football. Guess what? Texas Tech said, you're not going to get us with the same old trick again. They are prepared, and it's Big 95 that already has a touchdown on the day. Him and his buddy, Bradford Hutchinson, 95 and 97 in ring.
Texas Tech, they used their last timeout. They're going to get the ball back. And with momentum, they're going to try and get some. A 3 would be nice. A 7 would be outstanding.
Shuck just always seems unshaken. Right? Shuck always seems unshaken in these opportunities when his team is down. The offense has turned the ball over to no fault of his own. The offense is sputtering. He always just finds a way. Finding his way back. He's doing a great job of that today. See if he can steal even more of this momentum and put points on the board before the half.
Turk does his job. Outstanding kick. Price to the edge. And Price to the 40. There's a flag down.
You're going to get either block in the back or hold. It looked like a block in the back where he also grabbed him. So I don't know which one they're going to choose, but it's going to be one of the two, and this is going to come back.
During the return, holding number 6, return team. That will be 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down, Texas Tech.
J.J. Sparkman called for the infraction, and that'll put Joey McGuire's team in a bit of a hole. The ball would have been at the 40 without the penalty. And now it's going to be spotted inside the 20. Oh, my God, inside the 15 at the 12.
Yeah, you're going to see right there. He's got his hands on his back, and then he gives a little tug as well to make sure that he can't make the tackle. And obviously, they're going to call that every single time. That's why it was such a big return by Price.
Ends up being a 28-yard penalty.
Yeah, you got to shut this one down. Run a couple run plays. Guess not.
Well, Oklahoma, yeah, they do have 2 timeouts. So if Texas Tech, they don't try anything, the Sooners can just call a timeout to possibly get it back.
Well, I mean, that's a big game. Right, that's a big gain on first down. I think they're going to try and go and really go get points here.
Oklahoma's going to get the ball to begin our second half.
Got to guard the sideline. Got to guard the sideline. No timeouts. You can't allow Texas Tech to drive down and score.
Shuck. Out of bounds. Stops the clock, 37 seconds.
It's a great job by Shuck because Jordan Kelly gets through the line of scrimmage right away. He's done a good job to this point in the game. He clubs those hands down, gets there, and that should be a sack, right? The clock should continue to run, but Shuck finds a way to get outside and throw the ball away. Very nice job outside the pocket, so it's not intentional grounding.
Just a 3-man rush. Oh, my goodness. Dangerous pass.
Yeah, you know, earlier,
man too is Key Lawrence.
Early in this drive, I said he's probably shut it down. Because, you know, just you're doing so well. You got all the momentum. You probably shouldn't. And so he tried to sneak this ball behind Stutzman's head right as he expands. Very nice job and a good idea. But Price was not ready. It's actually an outstanding throw. Right? Price wasn't ready for it.
So this is kind of an important play. Oklahoma with 2 timeouts. They could get the ball back. Coming out of the backfield, Thompson. He'll get the first down. Thompson close to midfield all the way to the 46. That's a 27-yard gain.
What an outstanding call. You're going to get the true freshman Thompson on a blitz off the edge. And Texas Tech does a great job of having a plan, right, having a free release. And he's responsible for the running back. Running back sneaks out. Nowhere, nobody for him.
No timeouts for Texas Tech. That will stop the clock. The incompletion stops the clock with 20 seconds remaining here in our first half.
Shuck has found his groove in this offense, but Zach Kittley, as a play caller, has really found his groove in this game, and he's like calling the perfect play for the perfect defense. It seems like every single time in big moments.
Texas Tech, if they get a gainer, they need to get out of bounds. They're going to try middle of the field. Caught by Bradley. Bradley inside the 20. Down to the 10. Clock will stop temporarily. Red Raiders are going to have to hustle. I'm assuming you clock it. Clock is moving. And Shuck clocks it with 4 seconds remaining. Wow, what a sequence.
All right, here you go right here. He's going to go vertical and get into the middle of the defense. A very nice job, and he's nice and friendly, right? He's going to run, he's going to run, he's going to run. He's going to break right behind the Hook the Girl defenders, and he's wide open. Number 5, the safety Billy Bowman, is enticed by the corner route from the other receiver and leaves his position. A nice job by Shuck, driving that ball down the field, and a nice job by the wide receiver. Bradley running and getting as much as he can and setting up this easy field goal.
Wolf for Trey. 29 yards, our final play of the first half, and we can't get anything better than this. A 1-point game at intermission. Oklahoma led 14-0 at the end of the first quarter. Texas Tech wins the second quarter 23-10 to make it a one-point game. Right now, let's send you back to Los Angeles for the State Farm Halftime Show. We've got ourselves a ball game, loving it, Big 12 style. Lubbock, Texas, one-point game. Oklahoma leading Texas Tech. Glad you found us. With my partner, Devin Gardner, I'm Eric Collins. This game, it looked like Oklahoma was going to run away and hide. Devin, at one point, they had an 18-point lead.
Yeah, it was a little bit of a, they are who we thought they were. Oklahoma came out guns a-blazing. Mims show. Catching deep balls all over the field using that explosive speed, and then they slowed down. And Texas Tech got a hold of this football game, and they started to make play after play. It started with Thompson's touchdown, where they used the quarterback as a lead blocker, and then the quarterback got back there, gave him a little 1-2, and then the fillet, the layup into the end zone. Texas Tech has made this a game. It's exciting.
All right, through 30 minutes, there are your numbers. The time of possession is almost equal. Your total yards, both teams with at least 300 and one turnover aside.
Yeah.
We have an interception. We also had a fumble. A little bit of everything.
Partner, I can say that we've got ourselves a ball game.
I'm with you. Glad to be here sharing it with you on a Saturday night. Oklahoma going to receive the second half kickoff. And it'll be a touchback. Ball to be moved out to the 25-yard line. Two quarterbacks. Talked about to begin our ball game. Dylan Gabriel and Tyler Shook.
Yeah, Gabriel had those explosive passes down the field to Mims, so he has a little bit more yards on, through the air. But Tyler Shook really came on late in the second quarter, and he drove his team down, and he has shown that he is unshaken, right? He shows great poise even when they're down, and he has his team down one, but OU has the ball.
Difference in the game was a missed extra point by Texas Tech. Gabriel gives it to the first man through. It's Gray. Look at Gray go. Gray out to midfield. 25 yards to begin our second half.
Before the half, I said they need to get Gabriel going, and the best way to do it, get the ball in the hands of zero. Eric Gray.
Gray knocking on the door of the century mark. He's got 95 yards rushing. Right at the shoot tops of Jahlil Farouk. Incomplete, second and 10.
I mean, that's a nice play. It's a nice job by Joseph Adibare, but you have to get this ball up over and into Farouk's hands. He's wide open. You've got to give him a chance to run because he's got a lot of field. But great job by Adibare.
They fake it to Stoops on the end around. It's Gray. And Gray doing Gray things. Gray matters. It's a gain of 8 yards. And it'll bring up third down and short.
There's no gray area for Gray. He does a great job of sifting through the line of scrimmage. He always does. And he, like I talked about in the beginning of the game, he has a unique ability to slip in and out of tackles, as you can see him doing it here for a first down.
Another first down carry. Finally brought down by Kosai Eldridge. But depending on how much yardage they give him, that's a 100-yard day for Gray. Yep, he's now at 102 yards. DeMarco Murray saw him with that discerning eye, running back coach. Coaching up Gray big time. I had to wait till we were 11 on 11. Now we play. Again, they fake it to Stoops. Gabriel, a bullet, incomplete. That was Javonte Barnes out of the backfield. Maybe the pass was on the wrong shoulder, but it should have been caught.
Absolutely not. That's a perfect throw. A great design, taking the running back and running him up the seam. There are just too many guys for Texas Tech. He's wide open. That ball has to be caught every single day of the week. Barnes is going to want that one back.
Stoops wrangled out of bounds. It's going to bring up third down. Nominal gain of 3 yards for Stoops. Only a minute and a half taken off the game clock so far on this drive for Oklahoma. Barnes out to the 32-and-a-half.
You think with that call that OU thinks this is four down territory where they're going to just run the ball there, get some of it, and then go for it.
Their kicker, Zach Schmidt, his long this year is 44 yards. And this kick could be longer than that. So they're going to go for it on fourth down and five. Again, waiting for the subs to come in for Texas Tech.
Texas Tech is outnumbered to the bottom of your screen. If they would have got Gray this way.
Gabriel under pressure. Gabriel goes down. Tony Bradford hits a homer.
Texas Tech goes with the zero pressure and gets home. Number 11, Demetri Moore with the stop.
FS1 College Football is sponsored by Hampton by Hilton for the stay. First time in a long while that Texas Tech with an opportunity to take the lead. They're down one. First touch of the football in the second half. They had momentum at the end of the second quarter, and it continues. Jaron Bradley, a big gainer, down to the 30-yard line.
Why does this play work? The ball handling of Tyler Shuck was amazing. The ball was rolled all the way down. The running back was almost into the line of scrimmage. He pulls it out and makes a strike.
Out of the backfield, Thompson. Gave the old dead leg, didn't fool anyone. Out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Gain of one on the play.
No, the first quarter, things were looking bleak. But the second quarter, 23 points, 179 passing yards. The running game got cooking.
It really turned it up. It's usually the tale of two halves for Texas Tech, the tale of the two quarters. What adjustments were made? It's just a short commercial break.
Thompson, the stiff arm, down to the 21. It's going to bring up third down. That's a gain of six.
Man, Oklahoma has done a very good job. Even though they're lined up in their two safety shell, they've got those safeties sprinting down to stop the run game. But the problem is they're taking bad angles, and Sirajir Thompson is doing a very good job of avoiding and going and getting yards.
Third down to three, line to gain to 19. Empty backfield. Nehemiah Martinez gets the edge, gets the first down. Inside the 10 goes Martinez.
Watch these guys block. Very nice job getting on the edge and making sure that Martinez has the space to go. It's a numbers game. If you can match the numbers and have Martinez the guy who doesn't have anybody for him, you can gain yardage. Very nice job by Nehemiah Martinez.
Nehemiah hurtling down inside the 10 to the 7. It's a gain of 15.
Smith back in the game.
Donovan Smith with Shuck. Shuck is going to be the signal caller, it appears. Hand off Thompson. Again, the dead leg. Thompson! Touchdown, Texas Tech! The senior with yet another senior moment. Texas Tech leads for the first time.
Late in the second quarter, I said Kittley was getting in a rhythm, and he's really found it with this Smith package where he gets in the game, and Oklahoma doesn't know where the ball is going, and it allows Roger Thompson to once again get outside contain and beat the safeties to the pylon.
You know, Joey McGuire's card says go for it. They're leading by five. This is a two-point conversion and a flag. It's going to be against Texas Tech.
Ball start, number 76, offense. Five-yard penalty, retry.
Caleb Rogers. There's no way you go for it now, right?
Nah, I don't think so. But these referees have got good eyes because it was such a small movement. It's a small little rock back in his stance. Nice job by the line judge seeing it.
So here comes Trey Wolf. Missed an extra point back in our first half. And the lead swells to six. Texas Tech trying to break this hold that Oklahoma has had on them in recent years. They've got the lead, 10:52 remaining, third quarter. So Roderick Thompson beaming on that sideline. On senior day, his Texas Tech Red Raiders trailed by 14 points to begin our ball game. They were down 14 rip. They've gone on a 30-10 run since the end of the first quarter, and Sir Roderick Thompson moving on up. Had been tied with Byron Bam Morris on the touchdown list. He's now in third place all by himself. Needs to get really hot if he's going to move up to another spot.
Yeah.
You never know.
So you mean to say there's still a chance?
Oklahoma, second time they'll have the ball here in our second half. All right, Devin Gardner, your feet are on the fire right now. Second consecutive week that Dylan Gabriel in Oklahoma started out with their hair on fire. Great first quarter, and then petered off. What's the deal here?
Well, they have to find a way to make plays. And you saw in the last drive, they had opportunities at big plays. And in my keys to victory, I said they have to get through the trash at the second level. And that includes drop passes, right? They had a drop pass up the seam. And when Gabriel gives the receivers opportunities or pass catchers, they have to make sure they capitalize. Here, they have one safety high. One safety deep in the middle of the field. You can get Stoops and all these other talented receivers across the field, but they have to do it with a downfield passing game.
Play action to Gray. Out in space, the tight end Willis. Willis has now made four catches, close to 30 yards for him on the day. That's a gain of six, so four catches, 28 yards with a touchdown for Willis. Gray has the first down to the 39. Eric Gray already well over 100 yards, now at 116.
And you gotta love that convoy with that right guard and right tackle finding their way around and lead through for Gray.
Gabriel wants a bunch, has a man. Theo Weiss, touchdown, Oklahoma! Another big play for Oklahoma after a while. It looked like we were going to see another one, but we get one there. We're tied at 30. 61 yards.
There's going to be nobody in the middle of the field for Texas Tech. Great job by Dylan Gabriel driving that ball down the field, and the rest of this is Weiss. Does an outstanding job staying up and finishing the play. He fakes an injury there and then goes into his dance move.
30-30. Extra point. Breaks the tie. Oklahoma back on top. That's now four touchdown passes thrown by Dylan Gabriel.
We talked about it. Texas Tech has some vulnerability in the middle of the field. Take advantage, and Weiss takes huge advantage.
The big plays continue for Oklahoma. They have now got touchdowns of 37, 77, and most recently 61 yards to Theo Weiss. And Oklahoma leads by a point. Nothing like a 43-second touchdown drive.
Yeah, I mean, you got to take advantage when you have opportunities, and Oklahoma does a very good job there taking advantage of that Texas Tech defense that leaves the middle of the open extremely vacant.
Jordan Brown with a chance here. Brown had a 67-yard kickoff return in the first quarter, and this time gets absolutely stoned. Brought down at the 20-yard line.
So here it is. You got safety running down into the box, and then the safety that's available is on the other hash, right? He's on that side of the field. So now this isn't even a route. He's going to run as fast as he can and get to that vacancy. You can see Weiss right there. I mean, just throw it up and allow him to make a play. Nice throw by Gabriel and a nice job of Weiss staying on his feet and getting in the end zone. If Texas Tech is going to play defense that way, it's almost disrespectful, and you have to make them pay. Gabriel does a very good job there.
Almost disrespectful. You went there.
Oh, absolutely. No safety. Talented receiver like Weiss. Mills.
To Roderick Thompson. I don't think I've seen a more patient run tonight. Just took his time, picks up 4 yards. If he hadn't been patient, he'd be down at the line of scrimmage.
And he's just slithering. Right, slithering through the defense.
Senior from Irving, Texas, has played a ton of football for the Red Raiders. Almost better that pass was dropped. Xavier White couldn't hang on, but he would have been dropped right at the line of scrimmage, maybe even a loss.
Again, that's C.J. Colden breaking through the blocks, but Texas Tech's offense has been vastly different. First quarter, nothing. Since, pretty darn good.
Donovan Smith has come into the ball game.
Now they only use this in the red zone for this game. We've only seen him use it in the red zone. But remember, he's a talented passer. Has 1,500 yards passing on the season.
They put Smith out in motion now. And they run it on 3rd and 7. And they're not going to get to the line to gain. Looked like they had a chance to bust it, but it's now 4th down. They gained 5, needing 7.
Ethan Downs does a great job of seeing what happens and falling in and making the play. His job is to hold contain, right? That's not really his gap, but he finds a way to fall inside and make the play on Thompson.
All right, so the Red Raider fans disappointed. It's going to be a 3 and out. Austin McNamara comes on to punt the football away. Marvin Mims back deep to return.
We haven't seen much magic from Mims since that early first quarter touchdowns. Maybe punting to him could be a mistake right here.
McNamara averaging 48 yards per boot today. And that average is going to actually go up. That was a nice punt down to the 20-yard line.
Very nice.
50 yards, made up half the field. Oklahoma's got the ball and the lead when we come back. And it looks like we're going to have another shootout like we did back in 2016. Who can forget this one? Good golly. Patrick Mahomes and Texas Tech, 734 yards, 5 touchdowns. But Baker Mayfield, he got the last lap, 545 yards. That was to Joe Mixon. Sooners won 66-59. Man, everyone was gassed after that one.
A lot of points, a lot of yards.
31-30 is our score. Oklahoma, their second look. And a great stutter. Here comes Gray. Hey, Gray out to the 45. Eric Gray keeps on keeping on. That's another 25 yards.
Man, he just gets behind Gray and Guyton, the right guard and right tackle, as they pull around. And he gets going. And once he gets to that second level, he can hit his head on the goal post in a moment.
2 for a quarter for Gray this time. Gets out to midfield, a gain of 7. Some extracurriculars. No flag. Turn the page.
And it's extracurriculars for Braden Willis. Came around and put Krishan Merriweather on his back. He's not used to that. Krishan Merriweather is the guy usually delivering the blow. That time he received it from Willis.
Third straight carry for Gray. And he's brought down by Merriweather. Some revenge.
Yeah, those two are meeting quite a bit here on the last couple plays. Braden Willis and Krishan Merriweather. That time, Merriweather wins, right? He meets him on the other side and blows that play up.
3rd down and 1. Decisive cut for Gray. Good enough for the 1st down. Gray's been the workhorse so far in this drive. He'll catch a blow, get a cool drink of water, pat on the fanny. Javonte Barnes replaces him. Gabriel, dumped down.
Dylan Gabriel's fast.
Tight end Willis. Gain of 6.
Coach staff is really excited about Braden Willis. They love his game. I think he has a bright future going forward. 2nd down and 5.
Barnes trying to do a Gray impersonation, patient, looking for a hole, but the hole never opened up. Tackled by Kosai Eldridge. Interesting story about Kosai Eldridge. Everyone thought he's a senior and was running out of eligibility. He's a junior college transfer, and there's some question about how many games he actually played back in 2018 at his junior college. They're going to have to recheck the numbers, but there's a chance he could come back.
Mm-hmm.
You got to play 4 games, more than 4 games, to use up eligibility, and that they're not sure whether or not he played 4 or 6. He has to leave the game.
Stoops is uncovered to the bottom of your screen here. All right, they got the linebacker expanded. If he can get into the middle of the defense.
3rd and 4. Snap wasn't great. Hand off to Gray. And Gray's like a good stick of deodorant. Things get not so good. He makes it all right.
I mean, this drive has been a lot about Braden Willis, though. He does a great job coming across the formation.
They didn't get it. It's fourth down and inches. I thought he had it. Gabriel, no! They're not going to get there. Marquise Waters saves the day. Oklahoma going fast. They had a fourth and inches, and they don't get there.
That's an amazing play by Waters. He's going to come and blow up the miss and then react. React to the quarterback because it looks like a pull read for Dylan Gabriel. He says, I'm going to pull this, and he reacts and goes and makes the play on the quarterback too, doing two jobs at once.
So Oklahoma denied. Wow. They give the ball back to Texas Tech.
Sometimes going fast hurts you.
And you really got to be committed to going fast because you get plays like that every game. You wonder what if. Shuck, pass is complete. Nehemiah Martinez hurtling down the field.
Nehemiah Martinez's route running has really developed during his time at Texas Tech. He does a great job of getting vertical, swiping the DB by, and coming underneath for a catch.
24 yards for Martinez. Thompson, nowhere to go. Ethan Downs has been busy. That's a loss of a yard. Both sides with one turnover. Fumble lost by Texas Tech, an interception thrown by Dylan Gabriel. Shuck wanted to get it to Thompson. He was covered. So Shuck making something out of nothing. Oh, Shuck's down to the 20-yard line. And he saves a cheerleader. All is right in the world.
There's been a few times in this game where Shuck has been asked to use his legs, and he's used his vision to get to open spots on the field, and then he has the speed to get there. Very nice job. He's not known as a runner, but he has some of that ability, and he does a great job of making sure the cheerleader is okay as well. I mean, this young man is doing it all tonight.
Gain of 19 yards. We've gone under the 5-minute mark here in our third quarter. Thompson probing to the 18, but that's it. Woody Washington comes from his corner spot to bring him down. Texas Tech has had virtually no success against Oklahoma in recent years. Oklahoma has won 10 straight. More often than not, they put up huge numbers against Texas Tech. Donovan Smith into our ball game. Smith and Shuck in the backfield. There's Smith, number 7. He's been nothing but a decoy tonight. But he sets the edge. Brooks down to the 13.
Blasphemy. I will not allow you to disrespect the backup quarterback Smith, calling him a decoy. This is the second time he's been at the point of attack, and he does a great job of setting the edge and allowing his buddy to run around him. This Smith is doing an outstanding job. He's getting a lot of reps, not at the position that he naturally plays at quarterback, but he's doing a great job helping the Texas Tech offense.
Third down and 3. Red Raiders need to get to the 10. They're already well within field goal range. Shuck. I think he got there. It's going to depend on the spot.
It's going to be really close. He has to get to the 10-yard line. Does a great job of just getting behind Brooks and lowering his pads. I think he's got it.
And he has. Change move.
We saw this last week when it was winning time. They got Shuck in the running game a lot more, and you got Smith out on the field again, standing to the left of Shuck.
And a flag.
Ball start, number 75, offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Jacoby Jackson.
I don't think I've been in a game where there have been so many false start penalties by both sides, right? It's not a crowd noise thing. I think it's the speed of play from both teams. There's been so many false start penalties by the offensive linemen and sometimes receivers.
And sometimes you see it really early in the season, you know, week 0, week 1, week 2.
All right, now you got Smith to the right of Shuck. And I think He moves to the left. He's going out in motion.
Looking for Smith. He's open. It works. Touchdown, Texas Tech. Donovan Smith rewarded for biding his time and being a great teammate. Red Raiders back on top.
They're going to go for two. They tried to a drive ago, a touchdown ago, but they got a penalty for a false start. So they backed up and they just decided to kick their point. They're going to go for two now. But how about Smith, man? He has been a brush of fresh air for this offense. He's never been used this much. They use him in certain packages, never been used this much. This I'll go quarterback draw here.
End around. That's a two-point conversion. Xavier White. So the two-point conversion works. It's an eight-point possession for Texas Tech. It's their largest lead of the game, up by seven.
I mean, a little window dressing to start the play. You can see Smith there. He's going to head up the sideline, and nobody covers him. He's wide open. He's throwing his hand up, and a nice throw by Shuck to make sure the quarterback makes the catch. That's the second touchdown of the day for Smith. Shuck loves it, man. These guys are great buddies. They both shared in making sure this Texas Tech team is good on offense. And then Shuck just hands it off around the end. And OU has guys in position, but the power of Xavier White to get in the end zone, he would not be denied.
Man, the party's on the Texas Tech sideline.
Man.
I love it. 2:46 remaining in our third quarter. Oklahoma's been punched in the mouth. Their lead evaporated a long time ago, and now their largest deficit. Dylan Gabriel will lead his Sooners out. Ball will start at the 25-yard line. Sooners coming off a win a week ago against Oklahoma State. Remember, they scored 28 points in the first quarter and then zip for the remaining three quarters. Team's been inconsistent, to say the least, under first-year head coach Brent Venables. Jeff Levy, the offensive coordinator. That's Gray. Moves around, Gabriel. Gray stood up right at the line of scrimmage. Gray sitting on 156 rushing yards. Doesn't have a rushing touchdown. All of the touchdowns scored by Oklahoma have been passing. Gray makes it a third down and five. Isaac Smith with a tackle. Man, this crowd is going nuts, huh?
Yet another third down for Oklahoma. The one guy that just hasn't been used very much today, Stoops, number 12 in white. He's been so big throughout the year, and they usually run the ball in this situation on third and five. They have to find a way to get the ball to Stoops, I think.
Mims hasn't been targeted here in the second half. Blitz is picked up. There's Stoops. Just what you were talking about, Devin. A big third down grab.
This has been available all day. Texas Tech has played man-to-man defense and allowed the wide receiver for OU to freely release with outside leverage. You can get inside the middle of the field easily.
Gabriel dreaming. Too strong. Looking for his guy Mims.
He's saying that he got pulled and he has a point. He catches that ball. I don't know, for a touchdown he might fall, but he definitely gets pulled from behind. I think Texas Tech got away with one here. You can see the speed of Mims. He's going. Watch the right arm reach out, pull, just the slightest pull, and it stops him from being able to go get the ball. I think they missed one there.
Rashad Williams, fifth year senior, get the benefit of the doubt on a senior day.
Veteran move, only because he didn't get called for it.
Second and 10, snap wasn't great. Gabriel tries the other side, incomplete. Farouk, the intended receiver. Colby Miner coming up major.
Everything about that play was right. Farouk held his line, didn't run right up the sideline. The quarterback fades him out, but perfectly.
I think that was early too.
Play. I don't know. I think that's perfectly played
Miner
there by
totally
Miner.
Got him on the left arm.
He reaches in there as soon as the ball is entering. I think that's a legal play, and he pulled that hand away. I think that was much better defense than the other one. I think the other one might have been pass interference. I like that call. That no call.
Third and 10. Line to gain is the 42. Little check with me. Dylan Gabriel looking to the sideline.
The mismatch is up here. Right.
Gabriel, and he went in the wrong direction. Stoops and Gabriel were not on the same page. I'm assuming, Devin, that pass was to Drake Stoops.
Yeah, so Drake Stoops, he gets to the top of his route, and I think he even fakes Gabriel out because he gives a little left and a right, and then he goes out. I think Gabriel was expecting him to go in. He goes left, right, and it's so good that he goes out, and Gabriel maybe thinks that he's coming in. Miscommunication, whatever the case may be, there'll be punt.
Michael Turk. Ball is fielded on a hop by Miles Price. It's a punt of 42 yards, no return. How about these Texas Tech Red Raiders? They have turned it around in a big way. They were down 14-0 in the first quarter since they've outscored Oklahoma 38-14. Chuck has gone over 300 yards. That touchdown he threw to Donovan Smith a moment ago, his first. Four rushing touchdowns for Texas Tech. Quarterback keeper. Chuck is showing off some wheels tonight. That's a good gain on first down. 9, maybe 10. Now gonna mark him short of the line again. It's 9. Second and 1.
How about the athletic ability of big number 70, Weston Wright, the left guard, 6'6", 320, and gets out around and leads through. What a job and what athletic ability from a big guy that allowed Chuck to get through there and pick up that 9.
So Brett Venables giving signals. Sure looked like he said gobble, gobble, gobble. Second and 1. Thompson. The first down. Devin, question for you. 5-year player at Michigan. Did you prefer second and 1, or if you ran on for 9 yards, would you prefer to get 10 and get first and 10?
I would prefer to get the first down.
I just think second and 1 is awesome.
No, I want the first down because okay. You just don't know.
Okay.
What are you talking about?
Second and 1 is better than first and 10 in my world.
Whatever play you were going to call on second and 1, it'll be much better calling on first and 10.
Four fingers in the air. We've made it to winning time. Still nothing decided at all. Oklahoma and Texas Tech locked up in a good one. It is a 7-point game with 15 minutes to play. Texas Tech trying to knock down Oklahoma for the first time in a decade. We'll see if they can do it. Fourth quarter when we come back. What a line score that is, man. Oklahoma up 14-0 at the end of the first quarter. Looked like they were gonna run away and hide, but then the tables turned. Texas Tech leading as we begin our fourth quarter. 38-31 is our score. With Devin Gardner, I'm Eric Collins. We've got a first down at 10 for the Red Raiders. Sir Roderick Thompson, just a yard gain. You got a feeling about anything either way, Devin Gardner heading into our fourth quarter?
Now, I think that Sir Roderick Thompson being down is not good because he's been really good all night, making sure that they stay good down in distances. Try to take a look and see what happened here. Looked like a routine tackle at first look. Yeah, it's tough to see anything drastic there, but I think this Chuck has been really good. Run game, pass game. He's I've talked about it in the last few weeks. In some of the quarterbacks we've seen, and you know, people look at them maybe as game managers. And, you know, a lot of quarterbacks, nobody wants to be a game manager, but I think that when you have a good quarterback, he's a game controller. And I think that Shuck is doing an outstanding job of controlling the game. And it's so good to see Thompson walking off the field. But Shuck is doing an outstanding job of controlling the game. We saw him do it last week when they needed to drive. He put it together. And we see him doing it again tonight. He's been really, really good in giving Texas Tech everything they needed, whether it's run or pass.
Shuck has spread it around. 8 different Texas Tech receivers have caught a ball. On 2nd and 9. Pressure. That's the tight end. Baylor Cup.
Remember that thing I said once? Whatever they need, he kind of gives them exactly what they need, whether it's run or pass. Well, everybody's covered on that play. He gets through his entire read, right? 1, 2, 3, and the 4th option is the tight end Cup. And he finds a way to get a kind of a jump pass with people in his face, and they pick up another first down. See, that play was a little bit of a microcosm of what I'm explaining of him being in complete control of this game, and he's doing a very good job in trying to keep the ball away from Oklahoma.
1 minute into our 4th quarter. Todd Brooks in the backfield next to Shuck. Brooks had one man to beat and couldn't beat him. His name is Danny Stutzman. Stutzman leads the team in tackles. That is a short gain for Texas Tech, just 1 yard.
Nice job by Stutzman reading his keys, right? He sees the left, right guard pull around, so he meets him on the other side. He gets there, and he's right in position to make sure Brooks doesn't get much.
Sophomore linebacker with a bright future. He's got 12 tackles this evening. Blitz is picked up. Pass is behind Nehemiah Martinez, who got drilled. Trey Morrison laid it on him.
I mean, Stuck finds the right guy, but something we haven't seen, him being inaccurate. Josh Ellison, number 90, he gets in the line of scrimmage, and then he comes back, and he gets in the passing lane, right? So now the quarterback, Shuck, has to throw the ball behind, and it sets up Nehemiah for a back-breaking hit. Haven't seen many inaccurate throws from Shuck tonight.
Wow, with this play, both sides will have had the same amount of offensive plays. Shuck, incomplete. That was a decisive throw that was almost picked off by Key Lawrence. That's the 2nd time that Lawrence almost picks off Shuck.
And I'm just telling you, Key Lawrence is going to be mad at himself because Key Lawrence is right here. He should make this play. He's got eyes on the quarterback. He knows where it is. Oh! And just couldn't get there in time to make the play. He's the guy that's in the hole. When you play man-to-man defense, sometimes you have a hole player. He's sitting in the hole waiting and watching the quarterback to react. He reacts, but just a half a second too late. Nice defensive series by Oklahoma.
McNamara, no rush. And the punt out of bounds before it can get to the 20. Oklahoma with a chance. They've got the ball when we return to Lubbock. Marvin Mims has had a night. All we're going to show you came in that first half. What catch is just incredible.
Yeah, incredible catch. He's explosive. He's a guy that can take the top off the defense. And you sometimes look at OU's offense and say, well, why don't they do it more? Because he has an ability to go find the deep ball. This one here, Texas Tech just let him free through the defense. But he has enough ability himself to run through the defense, even if they are prepared.
For that one play there, Texas Tech decided to use the Ohio State defense. Mims hasn't had a touch, though, since the 6:38 mark of the 2nd quarter. And that changes. What a grab. Mims, another huge play. Marvin Mims comes up big when the Sooners needed it most.
At home, you're probably thinking, oh, man, they ran that clip right away. It's the production team. It wasn't us. It's our production team. They knew exactly what was coming next. Mims with another big catch. Hopefully, they don't get him for offensive pass interference. But what another nice catch and a very nice throw by Dylan Gabriel.
If that catch stands.
There are 2 fouls on the play. Ineligible player downfield, number 71 of the offense. Offside, number 0 is lined up in the neutral zone, the defense. Those fouls offset. We will replay 1st down.
You don't get a corner lining up offsides in the neutral zone very often. But Rashad Williams was the man who was guilty of the defensive infraction.
And Anton Harrison downfield just a little too far.
So wipe away what would have been a huge play for Mims. And it's first down at 10. It's like that play never happened. Shot out of a cannon, Reggie Pearson. Hit him with an elephant gun.
Reggie Pearson Jr., he's coming, and boom! Eric Gray, are you okay? Reggie Pearson Jr. out of Detroit, River Rouge High School. Wow!
Oh my! And Gray's a big man, 215 pounds. Second down and 10, Gray with a second chance. And out to the 30-yard line. Gain of 6, it's third down and 4. And Gray's gonna, is he gonna come off the field? Or, yep, Gray's, no, he's gonna be slid up wide, top of the screen. Third down and 5.
5 linemen, 5 guys in the box, quarterback draw.
Gabriel breaks that first wave. Lowers the shoulder, gets to the 46.
You see it all the time. You got 5 offensive linemen, you got 5 defenders in the box. You have enough to block, and you got 1 extra guy, which is the quarterback. Nice job by Gabriel. Recognize it because he has the option to throw the screen outside to the right.
Quickly back to the line. Gabriel wants a bunch.
It's going to be the defensive pass interference. Weiss, who are you, young man? I mean, all hands, they call that a head tap.
Pass interference, 0. Defense. That penalty's declined. Results of the play is a first down.
And I'm going to go up and over your head and snatch it out of the air.
These Sooner receivers,
they're special, man. I'm telling you, I've been clamoring all day. Downfield passing, attack this Texas Tech secondary. They just haven't done it, but they need it now, and they're using it right now. What a throw and catch.
49 yards on that pitch and catch. Gray brought down rudely. Krishan Merriweather. This Texas Tech defense hanging on like a cat on a screen door, trying to keep Oklahoma out of the end zone. Willis, touchdown, Oklahoma. We're an extra point away from having a tie ball game. Second touchdown for Willis. Sooners will go to tie. Zach Schmidt, the holder, Michael Turk. Tie ball game. Why not? 38 apiece. Theo Weiss, the big play to get Oklahoma within shouting distance, and then Willis drives it home. We're tied with 10:37. What a ball game. 38 all, Oklahoma and Texas Tech. 6 plays, 75 yards. Just a little bit over 2 minutes taken off the game clock. Second touchdown for Willis. 5th touchdown throwing, Dylan Gabriel. Jordan Brown watches it sail over his head. It's time for our team comparison, sponsored by Credible.com. We're talking quarterbacks.
Man, these quarterbacks have been good. I mean, I guess it's not quite Patrick Mahomes, Baker Mayfield, but it's getting close. These young men are putting on a show, a clinic, throwing the ball down the field. Obviously, Gabriel has more touchdowns and a career high for him. But Shuck, as I talked about, has been in complete control of this game, and there is still a lot of game to go.
A combined 1,064 total yards. Great news, Sir Roderick Thompson back into the game. After being down on the field last time that Texas Tech had it, he's blown down by Key Lawrence, who's had a nice day.
Oh, my goodness. These safeties on both sides are coming down and lowering the boom. Another big-time hit. Now, Coach Venables is a defensive guy, and it looks like he's at least adding to the play calls, right? Maybe he's not completely calling himself, but he's got a lot of input here, making sure that this defense plays better.
First-year head coach who clearly made his bones as a defensive coordinator, multiple national championships. Shuck can't get to the edge. Great closing speed and a tackle made by David Ukwebu. Gain of three. Ukwebu and Stutzman really good at their linebacking positions. Yeah, this for Brett Venables.
This coach staff really loves Ukwebu and his ability to be where he's supposed to be. And he does a great job. Oh,
that's the second time we've seen a quarterback in the neutral zone.
Oh, I mean, he attacked him.
Offside, number zero defense with contact. It's a 5-yard penalty, still third down.
So here in this fourth quarter, both corners wearing number zero, Woody Washington and Rashad Williams both called for being in the neutral zone.
And that's a little more than being in the neutral zone. He was about to put hands on the wide receiver.
Third down and two. This is doable for Texas Tech. Taj Brooks in the backfield, right side of Shuck. Option. Shuck has the first down. Needed two, got four.
I mean, I said it a drive ago, or two drives ago. Shuck, when they need a run, they need a pass, he's there and he's making the play.
Shuck, a dart, caught. This is Price. And Price gets an extra 3 yards because the Sooners are trying to rip it away. 19 yards.
Man, Price is so nice at the top of the route. He gets to the top of that dig route, gives an outside move. Colden goes right, Price goes left.
Looking for a bunch. A man's open. Touchdown, Jaren Bradley! What more do you want? 44 yards. Shuck to Bradley. And the Red Raiders back on top.
You want to know the cool thing about that play? They run the same play. Price and then a post down the field. Outstanding, just running fast as he can. Bradley outruns the defense.
4th lead change. We've been tied once. Texas Tech leads by 7. Another quick touchdown. Good times rolling in Lubbock. 8:43 remaining. FS1 College Football is sponsored by Hampton, by Hilton for the stay. Yards for Jaren Bradley, 7 catches. Scored the most recent touchdown, giving Texas Tech this lead.
We talked about the quarterbacks putting on the show. He and Mims at the wide receiver position, they are putting on quite the show themselves.
Miscommunication, much ado about nothing. Ball will be taken out to the 25. Oklahoma, last time they had the football, put a touchdown on the board. Dylan Gabriel, numbers looking really good. He has made it to 400 yards passing. 24 for 35, 400 yards, 5 touchdowns. Did have an interception that was way back in the first half, long forgotten.
I know Jeff Lebby and Coach Venables are happy about this offense finding a way to get in the groove. Remember, last week, 28 points in the first, nothing for the rest of the game. This week, total different story. Gabriel is on.
Faking it to Gray, looking down the field, and collision. That is Drake Stoops, who got popped with the ball in the air. I don't see any flag on the field.
Whoa.
Was it just two guys going for the ball?
I mean, it looks like Miner is attacking and trying to catch the ball. That's up top. That's an up top hit to a defenseless player. He gets him in the chest, though, so maybe that's what the official saw, that he got him kind of in that sternum area, which is a legal hit. He has to go head or neck area to a defenseless player, and he uses shoulder, so I think the targeting is off the table.
Little pop. This is Farouk. Makes a man miss. Farouk still on his feet. What a run. This is from one of your flankers. Showing some pop, 13 yards on that run.
That play was supposed to be bad from the beginning. A bad snap off to the right. Great job of Gabriel trying to corral it, pitch it forward, and then Farouk just goes bumping and stumbling and bursting through for a first down.
As always, got to bring in a couple of defenders, and we're going to wait until everyone's situated. First down and 10. Gabriel, again, a dart complete. Willis, the tight end. Willis, down to 23.
I love the poise and patience that Dylan Gabriel was playing with. Earlier in the game, he was moving a little too fast, but he rides that play action down nice and smoothly and hits Braden Willis right behind the linebackers.
Quickly back to the line. Stoops. Stoops. Did he? Not quite. Knocked down just inside the one.
Nice job of Gabriel once again using the pump fake to open guys up. Drake Stoops is open, and he's 190. If he's 197, he gets that ball in the end zone. Need a couple more quarters in his back.
Timeout on the field for an injured player.
23 yards on the pitch and catch, and we've got a man down for Texas Tech.
It's number 25.
Adrian Taylor Demerson, who's had a real big game.
Take a look at that last play again. Pump fake, and it opens up, right? It takes those safeties over the top, and then you can put the ball right in the seam, and a nice job of Stoops settling and being extremely friendly. You can see that.
Demerson right in the middle of that.
He's right in the mix. He's the first guy that makes contact. He grabbed his hamstring, right? And so when you're straining like that, I've been in that position where you're straining for extra yards. In this case, he's straining to push a guy back. You can have the strain in your hamstring, right? It can pull and grab when you're kind of exerting yourself. It could be a cramp, but you can see he's up and walking away. But he went right for the hamstring right away. You see they give him some liquid, right? So when they give him liquid, he goes for the hamstring. That's a place that cramps up a lot. He might have just cramped up there, and he's probably just going to sit out for a play.
It doesn't look like he's going to take off the helmet and go to the bench. He's going to stay in the defensive area in that huddle.
That's what this game has been, though, Eric. Straining, right? Both these teams straining and fighting for position, and they're doing an outstanding. This is an outstanding football game.
Our tied up from loose ends, both sides with all three timeouts. 7:40 remaining in our fourth quarter. It is first and goal from inside the one for Oklahoma.
Got leverage to the top.
And a touchdown. Easy touchdown, Jahlil Farouk. And Oklahoma is an extra point away from tying this one back up.
I mean, both these defenses just look tired. You're going to see Farouk come through, and it's just another touchdown pass for Dylan Gabriel, right? And it's kind of laughable because, you know, he just pitches it forward and Farouk does most of the work, but it's technically a touchdown pass, the sixth touchdown pass for Dylan Gabriel. Great job by Farouk getting the ball on the run, and we saw him earlier in that drive fight for extra yards for the first time. That time he's unabated all the way to the end zone.
Schmidt to tie the game. You betcha. And we're tied at 45.
90-point score so far. Eric Collins, the rest of this game is going to be great.
Chiefs-Rams.
What makes great matchups? Great coaching, great quarterbacks, and great setting. This checks all three of those boxes.
There's so much action in this game.
I haven't even mentioned Patrick Mahomes. Hello?
He's must-watch TV every single week.
The NFL, Sunday on Fox, home of Super Bowl 57.
At Domino's, next time you order two medium two-topping pizzas for $6.99 each, you could be in for a shock. Because Domino's is now delivering pizza with new electric vehicles across the country. With over 100 EVs on the road today and hundreds more to come, it's good for pizza delivery and better for the planet.
You're good.
I'm great.
What if you were a major transit system with billions of passengers taking millions of trips every year? You weren't about to let any cyber attacks slow you down. So you partner with IBM to build a security architecture to keep your data, network, and applications protected. Now you can tackle threats so they don't bring you to a grinding halt. And everyone's going places, including you. Let's create cybersecurity that keeps your business on track. IBM, let's create.
May the weather be cold and your tub be hot. May your hard seltzer be as bubbly as Jet Setting Number 7. And may the real vodka and real juice be paired with real good company. High Noon, sun's up.
Red Bull gives you wings.
Tuesday on Fox. Win or go home for the Stars and Stripes as Christian Pulisic leads Team USA into a must-win showdown against Iran.
A moment of magic!
Coverage begins Tuesday at 1 Eastern live on Fox and the Fox Sports app. And catch up on any match for free on Tubi.
The Oklahoma Sooners, a touchdown. Last time they had the football, they've tied this game at 45. Sixth place, 75 yards. And, wow! Yet another touchdown for Oklahoma. This is totally different than what we saw a week ago when they had that 28-point first quarter and then just fell off the face of the earth for the final three quarters of offense. Still won that game. But they've scored consistently throughout tonight's contest. Texas Tech, though, still dreaming big dreams. This would be a very important win for Joey McGuire and the Red Raider program. They have never defeated Texas and Oklahoma in the same season. Remember, they took down the Longhorns back late part of September.
If they're going to do it, it's going to be on the arm and legs of Shuck. That'll be big for Coach McGuire in his first year. Huge.
Tyler Shuck has been magnificent, 381 yards passing. Brooks is the back in the backfield. Nehemiah Martinez, the catch, that's a short gain on first down. We'll keep an eye to see if Sir Roderick Thompson can come back into the game. Senior runner for Texas Tech has been in and off, or on the field and off the field, last couple of possessions with an unspecified injury.
Yeah, that'll be big for them. Even though Brooks has run well, it's been the tandem of those two that's really worn this Oklahoma defense.
Ooh, that was a weird mesh. And that blew up the play from the jump. Todd Brooks didn't get it cleanly from Shock. Thompson still with his helmet on.
He got off the field very gingerly the last time we saw him, and he hasn't come back since.
Third down and six. The price, but it's a first down.
What an outstanding job by Nehemiah Martinez, not drawing an offensive pass interference. They used a pick play where he goes on the rail and Bradley comes underneath.
Oof. Another false start penalty on Texas Tech. One step forward, one step back.
False start, number 20, offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Lucky for them, five steps back in this case comes after they pick up the first down.
6:10 and counting remaining in our fourth quarter. Both these teams know one speed, and that's fast.
That's what I'm saying. Like, they're uniquely built, so no matter how much time is on the clock, they can always be in their 2-minute offense.
First and 15, and they go backwards. Ethan Downs again with a negative play. What a wonderful evening for Downs, the sophomore from Weatherford, Oklahoma.
Man, he does a great job of setting the edge. This time he comes across, and he's the guy that big number 75, Jacoby Jackson, is trying to kick out. He does a great job of getting that left shoulder and jamming it into the chest of the pulling tackle.
Loss of four. Second and 19. Shuck. Picked off! Picked off! It's Colden! C.J. Colden with a momentum changer for Oklahoma. We talked up Colden big time in that first half. He's been coming on last couple of weeks and now makes a massive play.
We talked him up, and rightfully so. He's going to come out from the left side of your screen. He made so many plays early in tackling and making plays on the ball, and here he is making possibly the biggest defensive play of the game. What a job by Colden. We've said his name all day, and now he comes up big for this OU defense. Remember, we've seen Coach Venable being way more involved in the defensive signals, getting the calls out to the defense. We saw him hyping up the defense on the sideline, and this defense stands tall.
So great starting field position for Oklahoma. Gray to the 30. You got to wonder how much gas that Raider defense has remaining in the tank.
Man, it feels like both these defenses are empty, but Colden finds a way to make a play. Colden.
5 minutes remaining. Gray. Nope, they fake it to him. Gabriel. Nobody home. Third and seven.
He's just throwing that ball away because he tried to get the ball down the field. Now, what OU has to be careful of is that's a RPO, right? And when I say RPO, I mean run pass option, and they're getting linemen down the field. They got called for it earlier, so Gabriel has to make a decision a lot quicker when he pulls that ball out on those run pass options.
83rd play coming up for Oklahoma.
Reggie Pearson, he had a big hit early, and he's down in the box. He may have an opportunity to get it to Mims behind him.
Gabriel, a little dump down. Gray's going to have to earn it. Doesn't make it there. The Malachi crunch. It's fourth down and two. Oh, this is interesting. And Brett Venables has already made the decision. He's going to go for the field goal and a three-point lead. Zach Schmidt.
We were just talking about how gassy Texas Tech defense is, and they stand tall and force this 42-yard field goal.
He made a 41-yarder earlier today. And it's all about Schmidt. Zach Schmidt gives Oklahoma a three-point lead. 48-45, the fifth lead change we've had this evening.
Perfect snap, perfect hold, and he nails it. Coach Venables approves.
So all it took was a turnover to give Oklahoma the change of possession, the short field, and they've got themselves a lead on the road.
Yeah, give a credit to that Texas Tech defense, though, right? Short field, give this explosive offense, who seems unstoppable with Jeff Levy calling the signals and calling the plays, and they find a way to stand tall and force Oklahoma into just 3 points. How does Shuck respond from the interception? That's the question. Can he still be on fire the way he was all game? Can he still make all the right decisions with his arm and his legs? We'll find out here shortly.
No chance at a return. The last time Texas Tech won against Oklahoma, we have to go back to 2011. Seth Dagey, 441 yards, three touchdowns. Alex Torres on that one. It is a Red Raider victory by two, 41-39. That was the last time that Texas Tech defeated Oklahoma.
Eric, look at that score. That's nothing. You got 48-45 here, baby.
All right, ton of time. So Roderick Thompson back in the game. Maybe a shot in the arm for Texas Tech. Short gain of a yard on first down for Thompson. Stutzman, yet another tackle.
Thompson limping again. I mean, he's got to come out, right? Yeah, he's going to head off the field. He's trying to go, right? Senior. Done so well, has been so big for Texas Tech in the running back field.
Mark Martinez, the man in motion. Clock moves down to 3:30 remaining. Shuck just flips it away. And
very savvy play.
Got landed on, but no whistle, no flag. Third and nine.
I like the no call on the roughing the passer or unsportsmanlike late hit, and a great job by Shuck making sure that this ball, he's outside the pocket, just flip it forward. It has to only get to the line of pass line of scrimmage. Does a very good job there. Set up a third and nine.
Oklahoma showing blitz. Here it comes. Oh, they trumped him. Beautiful play call. Brown fell down. What a play.
He's just going to go through, and he's the check down, right? Shuck buys a little time, check down, and then he goes airborne. Oh, that's dangerous.
Shuck dancing. Incomplete. Nehemiah Martinez can't hang on.
This is dangerous. Harmon says, oh, no, you don't. Man. Brooks got it pretty high, though. Harmon sent them even higher.
Second down and 10. 3:02 remaining. Three-point game. Shuck finds Brooks to the 40, and that's it. Clock continues to move. Both Oklahoma and Texas Tech with the full allotment of three timeouts.
Just has a knack for avoiding the sack and making sure that he finds a way to get that ball out.
Third and 7. Shuck's going to have to make it on his own. And it's now fourth down. Fourth down and 7 for those of you looking for BYU Stanford. It's available streaming live on the Fox Sports app and on FS2. We're going to stay here to our conclusion. Should be a great conclusion. It's a three-point game, 2:32 remaining. And Texas Tech, even with three timeouts, they're going to go for it on fourth down and 7. Ball on the 40-yard line.
Last two possessions for OU's defense. They've been good.
Shuck caught. That's enough for the first down. There is a flag down. Catch is made by Loic Fungi. There is a flag down.
I think this is going to be on OU pass interference.
Prior to the pass, holding number 2 defense. A penalty is declined. The result of the play is the first down. Correction, number 22.
Yeah, I was about to say they got the wrong number there. That's Colden, who made the interception the drive ago. Got a little too handsy trying to stop Fungi from making the catch, but Fungi does a great job of fighting through and find a way to make a sliding catch.
So on fourth down, the drive continues for Texas Tech. Now they got some wiggle room. First and 10. Clock's down to 2:10. Four-man rush. Complete. Close to the first down marker. It's a gain of 9.
Your favorite down and distance here. Second and one.
Love second and one.
Eric Collins loves a second and one. Let's see what they go through here. The full playbook is available. Big play action down the field.
Quarterback keeper. Shuck has it. Clock will stop temporarily. As the first down is picked up, the chains left to move. It's a gain of 3. Clock moving again. Shuck. Lives to fight another day.
At home, you may be wondering, well, if you're Texas Tech, you move the ball so swiftly, don't you want to use a little more clock so that OU doesn't have a chance? And my response to that would be, that's not how they play, right? They will be getting out of the rhythm and taking themselves out of what they really want to do if they start to go a little slower. And Smith is jogging back on the field.
Two quarterbacks in the game for Texas Tech, Donovan Smith and Tyler Shuck.
Smith has caught a touchdown and ran a touchdown, so we know he can catch it out the backfield as well.
Inside run, Brooks to the 29. Stuffman, another tackle. It's third down. Clock moving.
Donovan Smith is a setback. Still in the game. Now he's jogging off. The referee's going to stand over the ball and allow OU to make substitutions if they want. Remember, the play clock is still moving.
We're going to be under a minute before they get this thing snapped. Third and four. Design quarterback run. Shook. Woo! He got it. That took some effort. Tyler Shook has it up for the first down.
Man, you got number 12, Key Lawrence, coming out of the middle, and he's had some big hits. And Shook is not shook at all. He does a great job of sticking his foot in the ground, making a miss, and trying to get at least close to the first down.
He didn't get it. It's fourth down in inches. They're not even going to measure. And the clock stops with 31 seconds remaining. All right, an official review. This is way too important to not think about.
Man, I'm on the edge of my seat.
All right, we got Dean Blandino's going to help us out. They're going to look at that last spot because this is crucial. Dean Blandino, what did you see?
Yeah, and this is the best look. You're going to watch the left knee is going to hit the ground. Line gains the 24, the left knee hits the ground, and then he lunges forward. They marked it about a half yard short. I think this is a good spot. This will be a great look for the knee, and then you can piece that together with the sideline angle. Watch the left knee right there, and then he's going to fall forward. So I think this is a good spot. The ruling on the field should stand here.
Dean Blandino's got brains and eyes. I mean, he's got
He's got a nice stylist, dude. His suit is outstanding.
although I did hear Devin rule books earlier. Stop trying to steal the officiating guy nickname. Okay?
You know that's Eric. I haven't even claimed
it. I know. I heard you, Eric. Yeah.
Dean,
we don't have much
student.
In officiating. Let us have our nickname.
Okay.
Hey, but Dean, I don't know. I think you're going to give it to him. I think when they piece that thing together, that the ball's in the proper arm and it might be at the line to gain. I don't know.
All right, if you want to make it interesting, maybe a dinner, you want to, we can.
You know what? I think that's good. I think, you know what?
Yeah, you're right. The ball is in the right arm when the left knee went down. I'm with Dean. Originally, first blush, I thought that he had it. But when you do piece it together, the left knee down and the bottom part of his body, the right side, was behind the line.
Dean, I'm out.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. The runner short of the line to gain. Fourth down.
That was close.
The game clock will start on my signal.
Dean, that was close. You almost got me.
All right. Do you even think about possibly kicking a field goal here if you're Texas Tech?
What do you mean? It's definitely a thought.
It's fourth and one.
Yeah, it's 100% a thought.
It would be a 42-yard field goal or fourth and inches.
You've got points with the field goal, and I think they trust their kicker to make it. I don't see a scenario. I mean, it's 31 seconds left. I mean, I think you will just be fighting to get a little bit closer. They have three timeouts. I would kick the field goal, though, personally.
I would go for it. But last game of the regular season, 31, you got three timeouts.
The question is,
can you get the 1 yard?
No, that's not the question. You listen to this question. The question is, if you're Oklahoma, do you ice it? Yeah, they're letting it run down.
Yeah.
Oklahoma, you're not going to be able to take those timeouts with you. Do you ice the kicker and make them think about it a little longer?
So, Texas Tech calls a timeout. 8 seconds remaining. It's a quickie, just a 30-second timeout. Trey Wolf. He is the man of the moment for Texas Tech.
All their hopes and dreams for tonight rest on the leg of that man, number 36 in red. 40 to 49 yards, 8 of 14, 57%.
Last week, Joey McGuire was brilliant calling timeouts before Iowa State was able to kick a couple of field goals.
Yeah.
And those field goals subsequently were missed. Let's see what Brent Venables chooses to do. This is a 42-yard attempt.
He's standing right next to the official. I think he just said, hey, I'm going to call a timeout right before the snap.
He signals for it. There's the whistle. And Wolf gets a chance. Wow, he got a practice. And the practice didn't go very well.
He got blocked.
The timeout by Oklahoma. Obviously sliding doors. You don't know whether or not that would have been blocked, but that was.
Listen,
practice attempt by Wolf.
Listen, Josh Ellison, 6'3", 300 pounds. He absolutely bulldozed through that protection team. And if you're the kicker, right, no matter if the protection team let up or whatever, you got that kickoff and you saw it get blocked. What does that do to your psyche? Right? You saw it get blocked. Do you change things? Right? Do you change your mechanics? The one thing I know that he has to do, similar to a quarterback where you throw a pass and he gets batted down, it's an open guy behind. You cannot alter or change your mechanics because of the block. You have to do it the same way. Keep your head down and swing for the fence.
All right, we'll try it again. Now this is officially a 43-yard field goal attempt. And the kick is good. Trey Wolf ties us at 48. Ecstasy in Lubbock. So the timeout that was called by Oklahoma, we'll never know. But the timeout saves Trey Wolf from what had been a block.
Keep your head down, don't change your mechanics, and swing for the fences, and he nails it. Coach Aguirre loves it. And Coach Wendell said, okay, extra time. Okay, okay. I see you, Wolf.
What a ball game. 5 lead changes, 3 ties. Still technically 0.3 remaining. Texas Tech has not defeated Oklahoma in a decade. Trying to beat Oklahoma and Texas in the same season.
I mean, it's almost right that they go overtime, right? It has to. The way these two teams have played, the way these two quarterbacks have played, the way these defenses have tried to respond in certain spots, I mean, it just has to go an extra time. But there's still a kickoff return imminent.
So 2 seconds remaining in regulation.
You imagine it's going to be a kneel down and extra time, right, Eric? Gabriel's got a big arm. I don't think you can get it to the end zone from here on a Hail Mary.
Yeah, but you throw it down there.
No.
You're right. Okay, I'm with you. That's the kneel down. And yep, it is. The kneel down formation for Oklahoma. The Justin Case back. Marvin Mims. 15 yards behind the line of scrimmage. All right, let's do it. Overtime on a Saturday night in Lubbock, Texas. Where else would you rather be?
And that's the end of regulation with the score. Texas,
we're going to keep it here.
Oklahoma 48.
Last week of the regular season, but just in case. It's been a long season. Here's your overtime rules. We'll have a flip of the coin. You can choose either possession or the side of the field. Every team is going to get a possession. Devin on the opponent's 25-yard line. Of course, everyone's going to get a timeout. Then the 2-point conversion comes into effect starting in the second overtime period.
Yeah, and then after that, in the third overtime period, they rotate 2-point conversion tries instead of having the ball at the 25. And whoever wins the toss, they're obviously going to go on defense first, right, so they can see what they have to match and then get their opportunity. Man, this has been a really good ball game.
Oklahoma led 14-0 at the end of our first quarter. Texas Tech exploded for 23 points in the second quarter, and it's been back and forth ever since. Captains from both sides being asked to midfield. Shuck and Gray.
Okay, gentlemen, we're going to play some more football. We're going to play a series of overtime possessions until a winner is declared. Each team is going to have one timeout per overtime period. Oklahoma, you're still the visitor, so you'll be calling the toss. The winner will have their choice of offense, defense, or end of the field to play on. Got it? All right, same coin. One logo's head, two is tails. What's your call? Heads is the call. It is tails. Texas Tech has elected defense. What end of the field? We're going to play on the north end of the field.
All right, those are your particulars. Let's do it. Overtime from Lubbock, Oklahoma, and Texas Tech when we come back. What a kooky line score. 14-0 Oklahoma lead after the first quarter, and then both teams exploding, and we're deadlocked at 48 as we play overtime in Lubbock, Texas. These two quarterbacks have both earned their scholarship. Dylan Gabriel over 480 yards of passing.
That's a lot of yards.
Kyler Shuck, 431, a career high. Dylan Gabriel with another touchdown pass. He will tie Baker Mayfield's record for touchdown passes at Oklahoma. End around, Stoops, looks like he wants to throw! Caught! Gabriel, and he got popped! He got crushed! And Gabriel's down.
That is the second time for Reggie Pearson Jr. where he comes and absolutely lowers the boom. And Gabriel is still the transfer from Wisconsin, out of Detroit, played at River Rouge High School, a nice play design. He comes, and it's a legal, perfectly violent football play. Shoulder, head out of the way. What a hit by Reggie Pearson.
Gabriel is a left-handed passer, remember that. And it's his left shoulder that is struck.
I mean, that is so violent. That is what football is. Violence, but it's safe. Head out of the way. Only using your shoulder, and that's the result sometimes. I hope that Gabriel's okay to come get up and play, but what a hit by Reggie Pearson.
So Davis Bevel all of a sudden has to get loose. He's got the cleanest uniform of anyone in Lubbock.
Gabriel's smiling, though. He's smiling, and that's good because that violent football play, you don't want people to be injured on the field, but that is what football is.
It's a gain of 13 yards, so it's a first down for Oklahoma, but it costs them their quarterback. Gabriel leaves. He's up now on the sideline. He's at least got to stay up for a play. Davis Bevel, redshirt junior, Greenville, South Carolina, transfer from Pitt. In case you're wondering, Bevel has not thrown a touchdown this year. And now this is actually Brandon Willis. Willis, the tight end, takes the direct snap.
Let's go Wildcat. No. Bevel comes in a little cold. You don't want him having to handle the ball. Willis has handled the ball quite a bit, and Gabriel's back in the game.
Okay. So Gabriel back in.
You would think they would do Eric Gray, though, right? He's a running back if you're
going to
do the Wildcat.
Late addition to the field, Theo Weiss.
Now they're going to allow Texas Tech to get guys in, and the clock's already at 15, 14, 13, the play clock. And they're jogging off slow, but they allow them to jog at their own speed. 8, 7 seconds. You only get one timeout in overtime.
They get it off, but the momentum of the play was all wrong. Vidal Scott makes his biggest play of the day. It's a loss of three.
And I think it's smart for defense. Don't rush off the field, right? Jog slowly, waste the time. Now Oklahoma is scrambling. They're rushing, and a great job by number 42, Vidal Scott, getting in there and making a play.
Third and 11. Oklahoma can get a first down without getting a touchdown. Gabriel goes down. The defense stiffens. Joseph Adeyemi, and the field goal unit will have to come on.
How about Joseph Adeyemi?
the true freshman who's only in this position because Tyree Wilson, the star end, he was down with injury. He declared for the draft. Adady Ray makes the biggest play of his career to this point.
And he beat the best offensive lineman for Oklahoma, Anton Harrison. Just blew by him like a turnstile.
Oh, the good vertical and then come underneath the block to make a play on the quarterback.
And now it is Anton Harrison who's down on the field.
He got all the way to the sideline and then went down. He's getting up.
So on 4th and 15, no decision to be made. Field goal unit comes out, 34-yard field goal attempt, Zach Schmidt.
If Texas Tech is able to go get points, go get a touchdown, you got to point back to Reggie Pearson, the play he was able to make, staying home and seeing the quarterback trick play.
The holder, Michael Turk. And it, no good! No good! Looked like it wanted to hook, but it didn't do it quickly enough. And just like that, Texas Tech is a field goal away from putting this one all over.
Wow. Reggie Pearson, who was benched a week ago, makes the play of the day, what it seems like, and the field goal is wide right.
Wow. The officials right underneath the goalposts, and they were looking straight up, and they said that it was wide right.
I mean, just stoic, right? You would think he would be way more excited, but he knows he still has to go put points on the board with his Texas Tech offense to make sure that he wins this game.
From the 25, Brooks being pushed forward, maybe for a gain of 2. Second down and 8. We think that Texas Tech is probably without the services of Sir Roderick Thompson.
That should have been a tackle for loss. I mean, how about Brooks being able to get in the hole and shake 3 times and squirt through with guys in the backfield?
Donovan Smith, extra quarterback into the game. So it's Smith and Chuck, along with Brooks. A lot of options for Texas Tech. Smith in motion. Oh, no. No chance at all. Jonah Laulu with the tackle. It's 3rd down. Texas Tech very conservative first 2 plays of this drive.
He's in the middle of your screen. Does a very good job of hit, extend, disengaging, and getting into the line of scrimmage. Nice tackle because you want to keep them as far away as possible. Obviously, their kicker has the leg, but you want to make sure that it's a tough one.
3rd and a long 9.
I go speed option.
Quick hitter, Price. And where's the spot going to be? It's short of the line to gain. 4th down and 1 yard. But that makes the field goal a whole heck of a lot more manageable.
Remember, to open the overtime for OU, they designed a reverse pass trick play with Stoops to Gabriel. And Reggie Pearson, the safety, stayed home. A week ago, he didn't stay home on a quarterback blitz. He didn't get over the top, and they benched him for the rest of the game. He's in the game, and he makes what could be the play of the game in overtime. Woof with the attempt.
35 yards for the win. Did he? He did! Texas Tech, a winner! For the first time in forever, Texas Tech beats both Oklahoma and Texas in the same season.
I mean, every single player had a part in this game. There were opportunities for Donovan Smith and Tyler Shuck made plays and Sir Roderick Thompson and Reggie Pearson. The offensive line blocked well. I mean, this game was special. Miles Price, outstanding. Jaron Bradley,
at the wide receiver position. I mean, everybody had a hand in this one. Coach Joey McGuire has to be proud.
Texas Tech, their first time beating Oklahoma since 2011. It's been over a decade. But tonight they got it done. All facets of the game stepped up when they needed to most. Offense, defense, special teams, and it ends on the toe of Trey Wolfe.
He knew it was good. That's almost like Tiger Woods when he hits that putt and he goes, takes his hats off, and goes and shakes the hands because he knows he hit it perfect down the middle.
Trey Wolfe, the kick to send it to overtime. Trey Wolfe, the kick to win it. Two most important trays of his life. And it's a 51-48 W for the Texas Tech Red Raiders. What a season it has been. What a turnaround it has been, engineered by Joey McGuire and this new staff with the Red Raiders. Future's bright. Both teams still with something to play for. Texas Tech and Oklahoma, they both eligible. But all of a sudden, a losing season comes into play for Oklahoma. They go to their bowl game and they lose it. They finish 6-7. It's the first losing season since 1998. Not winning this game makes that something that's possible. While Texas Tech is assured of a winning season, even if they lose their bowl game 7-6, not too shabby.
Two overtime finishes both against Texas and OU. And here's the one against Texas. Wolf.
Veritable chip shot.
A little easier one there, huh?
Veritable chip shot, but a similar scene. What a 3-point win in overtime against Texas. And then late November, a 3-point win in overtime against Oklahoma. Close to a dream for Joey McGuire in his first season as a college football head coach.
And let's not forget, during the season, three quarterbacks start four games. Three different quarterbacks, right? You have Shuck, who's supposed to be the guy, comes from Oregon, he gets injured. And then you have Donovan Smith, who plays well, but he also gets hurt. And then you have to throw the redshirt freshman Baron Morton in there. He gets a little banged up. Tyler Shuck is ready to go, and he is a dandy today. Wow.
Heck of a ball game. Love sharing it with you, Devin Gardner. We had a blast this year. We're going to say goodbye from Lubbock, Texas. It's a win in overtime for Texas Tech over Oklahoma. Now we get you out to BYU Stanford with Alex Faust and Petros Papadakis.
I want to welcome those of you who just watched that overtime thriller.